isn't something StreamYard's messing with me. So let me just go to the comments here for a second. See who we scared off. Okay, so far this live stream is not going according to plan, but we'll get it on track. Good to see everyone. For some reason, StreamYard's messing up. Maybe I have to start this over if it doesn't stop doing that. But yeah, hey guys, welcome to GM Unleashed. Sometimes we have issues with StreamYard. Usually it goes a little better than this. But wow. Yeah, it's really messing up on me. I know why. Dang. Hold on. I think this is the issue over here. That's terrible, you know. I had this all set up nicely, and then everything all glitched out as soon as I hit to go live. Everything glitched. But I think we can get back on track a bit. Just give me a second. There. That should fix it. That ought to do it. Hi, Judith and Dan Davis, and of course, Stefan. Good to see you guys. So what I wanted to do is just review the long term and the short term, especially on gold and silver prices. And so what I do is blow this up to full screen, and I'm going to provide you a bit of music. And hopefully things go better. And I'll try to narrate a bit as we go too. As soon as that comes up to full screen. The reason I'm wanting to show this is because there's a lot of people that are new getting into the precious metals scene. And it's so easy to look at the short term. And I want to look at the longer term. So that's what we're going to do. But we're going to get a little bit of music going with it first. Here we go. I'm starting to think that chart, because that's a live chart. There we go. Because it's live. I chart it. It might be seen with it too. But that's okay. We want live chart. Actually, gold. And the blue line is the performance of silver. Going back to the year 2017. I'll actually zoom it over. I'm looking with the chat here every once in a while. And I'm out of the panel after 20 minutes. So look at that. Going back to 1997, gold and silver have pretty much the same rate of return. Total return of between 420 and 430%. It's glitchy. That's okay if it's a little glitchy. Let's see if it works out. I'm going to keep trying to go a little bit. OK. Okay. We'll try to keep it going. Yeah, the flying goose coins are cool. Yeah, they are. I have a few of those. Not as many as I'd like to, though. Okay, so I'm going to continue to zoom out on this so we can see the long term. And then I'll zoom in and we'll watch it minute by minute together. So this one here is going back to 1997. We're going to go further. That's now going back to 1970. And you can see in here between 77 and the early 80s, even into the 90s, how much better gold did than silver. So we're showing a total rate of return of 5,500% for gold from 1970. And a 1,475 rate of return for silver over the same period of time. That's sweet, Stefan. I have a couple of those. I might show them later. I just got to try to figure out where I stashed them. Yeah. So hopefully the audio is a little bit better now, and it's not glitchy. Let's zoom out even further now. Gold has reigned supreme. This goes back to the early 1900s, 1918. But really what's relevant is back here from when we went off the gold standard. So what's that, right around 1965? Something like that. Right there. Okay, so now just for fun, I'm going to zoom right in on this so we can see how it's been doing much more recently. So let's go back to much more current. Okay, so that's now showing since the beginning of May. And sure enough, you know, when silver and gold go up, silver tends to go up more, and when they drop, silver tends to drop more. You can see that clearly there. Let's see if we can see the movements on it the minute. So this is just going over the last hour or so. And this is live, so you'll see how they react to each other. This is kind of cool, but fun, cool and fun to watch, actually. There. I'll just leave that alone and let them run. We'll see what happens. And I am getting this chart off of Macro Trends. You can see up here, Macro Trends. And they use TradingView. That's what it's brought in by. Okay. So that was a pretty cool song. I think that's probably the most rough start of a live stream that I've ever had. And so now let's see if I can pop this back a bit. There we go. So I'm just going to see if I missed anything in the comments here. I probably scared quite a few people off there when this was glitching out. And it was mainly my fault. I forgot to pause the YouTube tab. Judith and Dan, is that the Super Leaf? Or is there a different one that's magnificent? Could be. I suspect you mean the Super Leaf. But there might be one that's called the Magnificent Maple that I'm not aware of. Okay, let's switch this back so you guys can actually see that chart running a little more. Like that. There we go. Hey, Flint, Michigan, thanks for stopping by. Appreciate that. I'm probably just going to focus on this chart here and we'll watch it together for maybe another 15 or 20 minutes. It'll be cool to see if what it is. It's charting silver, which is the blue line, versus gold. And this is in the overseas markets right now. They've opened up about an hour and a half ago. So it's actually kind of cool that we can watch the trading activity live here. And if you guys have any questions for me, or if you want to come up on the panel, let me know. I might very well just drop a link to that. But in the meantime, what I'm going to do is get a little more music going here with it. And I can chart other commodities too if you want, like copper, nickel, platinum, palladium, oil, all that stuff. I think right now most commodities are actually a good buy because it's priced in fiat currency, and the fiat currencies are being devalued. It's actually looking pretty quiet here. I'm gonna watch it with you. We'll see. It's pretty low volume. The volumes are down at the bottom. What I'm hoping is there'll be a big move, either up or down, that we can watch and see how much more volatile silver is. Seems to me there's about a 2-to-1 magnified return with silver, either way, up or down. Potassium. Yeah, Judith and Dan, I think it's a process. It's going on. Just like digestion, it takes a while for things to move. But it is going that way. And really, if you chart gold in pretty much any other currency other than the U.S. dollar, it's done fantastically well. Like, the U.S. dollar has been the strongest currency. So you're going to have the worst return when you're looking at it in U.S. dollars. And so you're right. As the U.S. dollar weakens, if it continues to weaken, gold should just continue to go. Stefan, what are you laughing about? Is it the potassium thing? I think so. Hi, Independent Many, Indy, and No IQ. I know some people don't like to watch charts, but that's what we're actually doing right now. We're watching the price action in the overseas market, with gold being the gold line there and silver being the blue. Potassium, yeah. Macro Trends doesn't have potassium on there. I want to keep it on this for a bit. just because I find it interesting and I want to share it. We already went through the longer term, so anyone that's just popping by, if you back up even 5 minutes in the stream, you'll see the longer term. Yeah, macro trends is pretty good. And they're actually using, what is it here? TradingView. But yeah, macro trends, they got silver. Silver prices, 100-year gold prices, life. Dow to silver. And this is just precious metals. They've also, hold on, I just got to stop this thing here for a second. Hold on. Before it goes into an ad. Hold on. Okay. It didn't go into an ad. Give me a second. There we go. Okay, we got that shut off. I want this one. Right. So they've got a stock screener, stock research, market index, indexes. Precious metals is the tab that I'm in here for that brings you to this this chart we were looking at. But it also covers energy, other commodities, exchange rates, interest rates, economy, global metrics. So it is, it's a good site if you want to just get some decent overview of what's going on in various different markets. Compare presidents and Fed chairs. I don't think they have that in here. If you've got a link, THS, that shows that, or is it in there? I'll double check. Yep, playing music is good. Did it say it's in there? Energy market indexes, stock research. Maybe it was in there. Let me double check this comment here. Presidents and Fed chairs. Just looking to see if it's in here. Fed balance sheet versus gold. Okay, THS, you'll have to drop the link in the chat for the link for that one, or you got to tell me which tab it's in. I kind of want to keep it here for now. I was kind of hoping to see silver blast by gold, but it didn't do that yet. Here. We'll fire this up. See if anyone recognizes the song while we watch this. Yeah, the premiums are going absolutely crazy. I'm actually cooling right down on buying right now, and I'll actually show you why. But I can sum it up into the fact that I like to buy it on big smackdowns. I don't like buying when it's high like it is right now. You know, I buy a little bit here and there, but I'd rather build up some cash right now and wait for the smackdowns, because they happen all the time. And then as it's going up, I just ride the wave. Okay, so we'll go back here. Let's zoom out a little bit. I want to go back to maybe daily. And then we'll come back to this really short term again. So I want to go back to this most recent SmackDown. See, this is what I talk about, what I mean when I say a big SmackDown. This is the type of area where I like to buy. You know, went from up 8% to down 24%. I'd be a buyer here too. But right now, especially with the premiums, it's crazy. Okay, so this is where I want to be zoomed into. Right around there. So this is going back to September of last year. We've got silver up 31.8% and gold up 15%. Look at that, it's almost dead on 2-1. Hey Jeffrey Jackson, good to see you. Yep, we're doing, having a good night here. Just watching the charts move a little bit, listening to some music, chilling out. I might open up the panel a little bit, see if anyone else wants to come up and chat. But it's interesting. This was actually inspired by a Solidate Metals video earlier today where he was talking about silver was going to be having, I forget the exact word, was it a struggle? Or that it was going to have a tough time the rest of the year. I think I put a comment in there that I'm betting on silver being somewhere between 15 and 35 by year end, which I figure is a very safe bet. No IQ. 2675. To 1. I'm not sure what you mean by 2675 to 1. Unless you're saying you bought an ounce for 2675, but that seems incredible. Oh, maybe to a dollar. I think Noike he's talking constitutional. That's it. Judith, you've been buying 10-ounce bars instead of tubes, but still buying on sales. Cool. Yeah, I like the 10-ounce bars too, but I didn't really get too many 10-ounce bars until I felt comfortable that I had lots of the tubes, just the 1-ounce denomination, just because so much easier for bartering small items. But yeah, that's the great thing with silver and gold. You know, you can go right from very small ticket items with your silver to medium size with your silver and your small fractional gold to, you know, massive purchases if you've got the large gold. So between the two of them, they've got everything covered, which makes sense because it's been that way for a long time. Okay, so 26. It's weird, no IQ, and I guess, yeah, it was also Judith that was saying that the price of the constitutional is crazy high. I remember it was only a couple of years ago, I thought people were saying, you know, a good deal on constitutional is 20 times face, which would be 20 to 1, but that could have been, could have also been just what spot price would work out to, which of course is a great deal. Okay, nobody guessed that last song. In fact, nobody put in the chat on any of them yet, which is fine. unless I missed it. So let's zoom back in on this chart here. This chart's going back to September of last year. And that chart looks really, really good, but I did pick that one. Let's go back way out again, just to show. That's gold versus silver, according to macro trends, going right back to the 1800s. So I don't think that all of that is necessarily relevant, but certainly from here is relevant. And yeah, sure enough, gold has just been kicking silver's butt over the long haul. But that could mean that, you know, silver's relatively cheap. That's how I'm looking at it. Yes, no IQ, you got it. Money for nothing. And I might just cycle back to the first ones because not everyone was here. Had some turnover. Dire Straits. Okay, so that's our long haul. Going back to the 70s. This is much more shorter term coming up now. This is just the last day or so. Gold's up, silver's down. Last couple days. That's a good one there for showing how stable gold is relative to silver. How much more volatile silver is. It's actually a fantastic chart for showing that. So I think what I'm going to do, since I've cycled through what, 4 or 5 songs already, is after this, I might switch it to platinum, and I'll just cover platinum on its own, gold by itself, silver by itself, and then I'll probably shut this down. Let's go short term again. Nice. Okay, just because I can't tell who's coming and out, I'm just going to reiterate again here. I'm just showing the chart of gold and silver as they're getting live at this very moment. And I've just been playing a little bit of music in the background that has money as a theme to it. And we can switch topics if there's anyone that wanted to discuss anything else, but... I figure this is money and music are both great topics, so we mix them together. this is charting the very, very short term. Let's actually move until they're together. It's tough to manipulate that. That's a pretty good shot there, though. There's copper. Sure, I'll show copper. We've been focused on this for a bit. Just give me a minute. Copper is in commodities. We'll see. That's actually a good question. I hadn't charted copper in a while. Give it a second and it'll come in. It's taking a minute, but it'll come in. It is taking longer than expected. There it is. And I always uncheck logarithmic scale, because to me it skews everything. Looks like it's around 425. This chart's going back to 1960. So I'll switch it to 1 year so we can see it better. That's copper charted over 1 year. It did have a big run up though. Let's go 5 years. There you go. Yeah, it was down to like just over $2 a pound. It's around 389. That's still a pretty big drop though, from $5. Copper's more volatile than silver. Hey Ronnie, how's it going? Yep, no IQ, you got it. Pink Floyd money. Absolutely. Hey Ronnie, we were charting silver and gold, and now we're charting copper. Copper basis. With the ads. There we go. Over 5 years. But you know what? I wouldn't be going out and buying the copper bullion unless you can get it, you know, for just a little bit over melt value. Certainly don't be paying the, what is it? A lot of places want like $3 an ounce. It's crazy. Best way to get copper is scrap copper from construction sites or recycling it from wires. Oh, hey Simone, how's it going? We got the copper chart up right now. We're listening to some music. If anyone wants to come up, I'll drop the StreamYard link. And I might just do that in a few minutes anyway. We'll see. What else did I want to cover? Oh, I wanted to cover platinum. We already covered gold and silver. We'll take a look at platinum. Got to go back to precious metals. I think platinum's a pretty good investment too. Or asset. Where's platinum? Platinum. There we go. Yeah, what is it? I think platinum is 10 times as rare as gold, approximately. Something like that. So we're just pulling up the platinum chart now. And then what I'll do is I'll open up the panel because I've already covered pretty much everything that I wanted to. As soon as this comes in. And I actually haven't checked to see if anyone else is going live tonight. But anyone that's in here that's got a wrench, feel free to post yours or other people's links. And again, I don't like looking at these charts in a logarithmic scale, so I always uncheck that. That is the price of platinum on the paper markets going back to the 60s. When it was around 200 in the 60s, it's gone as high as almost 2200 around the year 2008. Came back down to 600 and it's that's what this says. This says it's 1114 an ounce as of May 10th, which is today. Hold on a second. This thing gave me an ad. Okay, so I'll just pause that. That's weird. Pause the ad. That's paused. Okay, so just bear with me because I'm switching back to StreamYard here. Awesome, Ronnie. Judith, you bought tube of the copper legalized at rounds. Leaf on it, $35. Yeah, that is good money. And actually, I have a buddy that's done that too. He just saw, you know, when he goes and plays poker or whatever, he'll pull a couple of those out, flip them around or spin them on the table. And then, of course, his buddies are like, oh, what do you got there? You know, let me check that out. And then he'll sell them for $5 or whatever. That's awesome. Okay. So we're done looking at charts now. Ronnie, you can go back if you want, or if you want. Yeah, I'll pull that back up for you. Just hold on a second. I'll pull the silver prices back up one more time. And then actually, you know what? I'm going to put the StreamYard link in here first, and then I'll show the silver prices again. And then we'll see if anyone wants to come up. There we go. And I would have my camera on, guys, but I'm just on a little camera. So when I'm maneuvering around here on the tabs, I got to be right up to the screen to see what I'm doing. I don't think anyone wants me that close in their face. Okay, here we go. Silver prices today. So I'm just going to pull this up in the background and then I'll do the share screen with it. I think it'll come up quicker this way. So while that's getting pulled up, I may as well tell you we had a beautiful day here today. It is currently about 76 degrees Fahrenheit. About 22 or 23 Celsius. Beautiful. Okay, so let's come in now. So I will do the share screen on that. Yeah, and I am going to be upgrading my computer here in the next month or so. So doing this stuff will be a lot quicker. It'll be a lot better. And of course, if I go on to the other live streams, everything will come through clearer there too. Okay, so there's the price of silver being charted. And I actually like, prefer those candles like that. Okay, Judith and Dan, thanks for stopping by. Hope you have a great, excellent supper. Okay, so that's silver price, and actually that's worthwhile me zooming in. I don't know if you guys can really see that, but here, this was today. Uh-oh. Where there was a massive increase in volume for just a very short period of time. Right here. See this green bar? That's volume. So like that, 15 minutes. So that's very short term. I'll show you the longer term here, Ronnie, on silver. And anyone else that wants to see. I think this is the most relevant time frames. Back here is 1963. And when was it? The last year there was silver in the American coinage, circulating coinage, I think was 1965. It's right around there. So that's charting the price of silver from the time that the currency and the coinage was debased until now. And so the price has gone from about $2.13 to where today it's at $25.40. And that chart, I think, is great at showing the volatility as well. You can see those huge spikes and the huge drops. And so a lot of people, there's some people that love silver and there's some people that hate it. And a lot of the people that hate it because they bought in or around this spike here. Or this spike here, you know, very difficult to recover from that. So just like any other type of thing, if you're wanting to view it as a bit of an investment, you want to buy low and sell high. You don't want to, the best way to lose money is to buy high and sell low. So I don't want to oversimplify that, but that's where we're at with that. Okay. To do that one again. We'll do this one more time here. There we go. That's better. Okay, stop that. And we're back. Thanks, guys. That was a lot of fun. If nobody else comes up on the panel, I'm going to shut it down after this song is done. I don't need to buy it for the long term. About it. Yeah. It's beautiful. Yeah, me too. But I don't like buying when it's at the peaks. You know, I'll buy a little bit here and there. But even right now, I'm just actually raising cash because it gets beat up every once in a while, and that's when I like to buy. Are you coming up, Ronnie? Come up and say hi if you want. Tell the good folks about your channel. No, I don't trust the dollar either, Ronnie, because it's designed to devalue by 2%. Awesome, right on, man. It may take 30 seconds for it to pull you up on my computer, but... So for anyone that doesn't know Ronnie, he's a great guy that I met, maybe 3 or 4 months ago. Yep, take your time, Ronnie. I'll keep this going for you, for sure. And he discusses a lot of what's going on, current affairs. And he's been around long enough. I think he said he's 179 years old. So he's seen a lot. And has a lot of wisdom, but he's still keeping on top of the current affairs way better than I can. So I like going over to his channel and Big Chap, who's another friend, and they keep me on top of the news that I don't hear on the mainstream. Yeah, you're all good, Ronnie. I'll keep my eye open for you. And the other thing that's cool is Ronnie's been joining in on some karaoke streams too that I've been on. And he does a mean Johnny Cash cover. Mean meaning good. And as far as music goes, if there's any requests from the audience for a song for me to play, if I can find a karaoke version of it so I don't get a copyright strike, then I'm good with playing that too. Okay, so we got that done. That's good. Okay, so I'm just going to shut my camera off here for a minute just because it takes the pressure off me for a second. And as soon as I did that, look what happened.
What's up, JM?
It's magic.
Yeah, I'm telling you, man.
Right on. Great to see you.
Good to see you, brother. The marvels of modern day technology.
Yep.
No, I got the notice late that you were on. I don't know if it's my fault or theirs, but either way, I didn't see it until, you know, it's, I guess you'd gone past gold and silver or whatever, but
yeah.
I bought, you know, for me, quite a bit of silver again yesterday.
Nice.
Now what I'm trying to do is, you know, is because I've never been in the precious metals thing before.
Yeah.
And so I'm just getting my feet wet.
Yeah.
And so the next time, you know, depending on how, of course, I'm going to wait a while, you know, and see exactly what happens, because I know the the dollar and everything is in, not just the dollar is in trouble, but you know, the whole U.S. is on the verge of being declared insolvent because of the Congress hadn't raised the budget yet, or the
debt ceiling.
Yeah. So, I'm thinking very seriously about, well, next time I won't buy silver again, if there is a next time, but, and I don't know, you know, it's just going to just be how things go. You know, if something happens and, if they can figure out how to get the economy and everything back under control, which I kind of doubt it myself, you know, but if it were to happen, well then, you know, I may go another direction, but as it stands right now, I plan on sticking. And I know people always, you know, say, well, invest in something on the stock market. You know, I don't trust anything right now.
To me, like the stocks and even cryptocurrencies are, well, not are, they can be great for speculating. You know what I mean? If you want to trade in and out, because you can do it at a relatively low cost. But just like with most things in life, if you want to go for those big, big returns, there is going to be risk there, whether you see it or not.
Oh, no doubt about it. And that's what I don't want to take, you know, and with the shape that we're in right now, you know, not just our country, but really the world.
Yep.
To me, it just seems like you know, you're always weighing one thing against the others, which one is the safest for me. You know, I mean, I'm definitely not a rich man by no stretch of imagination. So I try to be, you know, extremely careful for myself in what I look at and what I buy and what I put my trust in. Because, Jan, to tell you the truth, in the Bible it says that, you know, gold and silver are God's money.
That's right.
You know, so that's what I mainly go by.
Yep. And, you know, I think a lot of people, I'm not a incredibly wealthy person either, but and most people aren't. You know, 95% of the population, at least 95, maybe 99, is not wealthy.
I'd bet more along about 99%.
Yeah, but you know, to have a little bit of silver and a little bit of gold, you know, or whatever you can, I think is a great, great idea. There's always a fine line. Hi, Simone. Sorry, I didn't really say hi to you again earlier. But
what's up, David?
It's a fine line between the two acronyms, FOMO, which is fear of missing out, and FUD, which is fear, uncertainty, doubt. Right?
Gotcha.
And I don't like being motivated by fear.
Oh, me either.
Right? That's... usually fear is not the good motivator, although it can save your life from time to time. But
well, let me ask you something. Do you think that all right, now taking the present day situation into hand, into thought, with the shape the country is in, the world is in, that the dollar is in, all that, and I'm talking about against BRICS and all that.
Yep.
Now that's the way I think of things right now. And so when you do, and there, to me, there's not any real companies on the stock market. I don't care what they are that I myself in my frame of mind could get, you know, interested in enough to put what little money I got into them.
Yeah.
And so that's why I go with the precious metals, because I do definitely believe that it's God's, you know, money.
Yep. I think it's a really good foundation, and for people like real estate is too, you know, in some ways, but with the precious metals, it's so much easier to barter with or to make a purchase. You know, you've got the smaller increments with land. It's tough.
Absolutely. You know,
sell off an acre or do whatever. So.
And did you know the way it's set up? I don't know how it's set up in Canada. And I may not state this right, so people can, you know, go look at it for themselves. But in the U.S., if you own land somehow, and like I said, I'm probably not stating it right, but I want to get this out the best I can.
Yeah.
But if you own land, then you have more of a say-so in the way the government operates than you do if you don't own land. I can't remember exactly how it works out.
It makes sense.
Yeah, it's kind of weird. You know, you'd think that, you know, just being a citizen would be enough, but it's not enough.
Yep. Just hold on a second, Ronnie. I'm going to pin that StreamYard link. I'm not sure. Simone or someone else may want to come up.
Sure. I hope David can come up.
Let me just see. Where. I wonder if I accidentally closed that. No, it's over here. Let's see where that went. Oh, and I'm going to close this poll, too. Some votes. Everyone said they think it's a good idea to own physical silver and gold.
Well, God bless everybody. I know that's the way I voted.
Yeah. It's tough to say no to that.
It sure is. Yeah, like I say, particularly when you look at how things in the world are today with all the money situation, and they're right now they're in the process of fighting back and forth between, you know, the dollar being the world's reserve currency, and they're trying to bring in another one. So
yeah, the only way to go is to go back to gold backed. And in order for it to be backed, in my opinion, that means it needs to be transferable, you know. So for example, right now, the American Gold Eagle has $50 stamped on it. And the American Silver Eagle has $1 stamped on it. So that says to me that if it's going to be backed, it has to be convertible, meaning I can take a $1 bill into the bank and convert that for an American Silver Eagle, for example.
Yes.
Or take 50 cash and convert that to a gold eagle.
That's certainly the way it ought to be. I definitely can't argue with that.
Yep. And then, like, the problem with that is there will be a run on the metal and everyone will be transferring to that, right? But once it stabilizes, can you imagine how much the price of everything will drop? You know, because a dollar will be worth an ounce of silver.
Exactly. That's I don't know if you caught any of my streams on that subject or not, but I've talked about it quite a bit, you know, and how I think it's going to work out once this is all, because I do believe we're going back to precious metal based system one way or the other.
Well, I know for sure you were probably a very young man in the 1960s, right?
Oh, yes.
Can you tell me and the audience approximately what would a dollar buy you at a variety store or a grocery store back then?
Oh, man. Well, I think like if you wanted a soda pop, it would cost 5 cents.
Mm-hmm.
A loaf of bread might cost 15 cents. And for me, being a smoker, and that's the best way I can put it. Right now, a pack of cigarettes would cost between $7 and $8 a pack. Back then, they were a quarter a pack.
25 cents.
Yeah, 25 cents a pack.
Yeah. So that's probably the inflation. It already started kicking in then. But yeah, so that would mean you could buy 20 cans of soda for a Silver Eagle.
Exactly.
For a dollar. So it would bring everything back, for lack of a better term, back to par.
Absolutely. That's exactly what I think. And, you know, when I try to explain it, it may not come out, you know, as understandable as it would if someone like you explained it, but I do the best I can, you know, with my
great. You do great.
Well, I think what it's going to be, and, you know, correct me here if I'm wrong, but it seems to me like what it's going to be is, I'm almost positive that the whole, at least the U.S., the whole look of the dollar and everything is going to change. And it's going to be completely new. It's going to be called rainbow currency. And if I'm saying anything I shouldn't say, Jim, please stop me. I mean, I don't think I am, but you never know.
Well, we'll just say, you know, these are just opinions and it's for entertainment. And I wanted to say hi to Silver Wolverine. Ronnie, I don't think that you've met Silver Wolverine, but Ronnie, SW, both fantastic people. You're welcome to come up on the panel. We are actually talking about silver and gold, and really getting into the topic now of the currency being based as opposed to what we have now, which is debased.
Absolutely. And well, as you know, the dollar now is what's called fiat. You know, in other words, it's worth nothing. It's based on nothing.
Yeah.
Other than oil, you know, that's what they based it on for basically forever. Well, ever since they took us off the gold standard back in the early 70s, I think it was.
Yeah.
And so now that's why all the other countries in the world are wanting to get off the, you know, don't want the dollar to be the reserve currency.
Yeah.
It's because of that. It's just not worth anything.
Yeah.
But when we go to the precious metal back system, now that's going to be a totally different story. I mean, you know, like, now see if you agree with this, JM.
Yep.
For instance, now let's say a new home would cost you $350,000.
Yep.
And when it, if it does what I think it's going to do, and it, you know, it changes, like I said, well, then a new home will say cost you $50,000. The $350,000 home will cost $50,000. And yep. That's what it'll be worth, you know, as on the, you know, how the county appraised it or whatever. But it'll still be as worth as it, as much, if not more, than it was before, because it's backed by precious metals.
Yep.
Does that make any sense?
Absolutely. And now 79 has entered into the chat. I don't think you've met her, Ronnie, but she's also fondly referred to as Terry 79. And I wanted to give Silver Wolverine an invitation to come up to the panel if you'd like. Just so you know, Ronnie, Silver Wolverine is in the Wolverine state. And he loves precious metals and really keeps up with the information at the U.S. Mint. And is a wonderful resource for anyone in the states that's, you know, looking at getting into the precious metals. Right. Yeah, I met him through the Salivate Metal Channel.
There's so many people that I've met here that's from Michigan.
And, yep.
You know, it's amazing.
Yep.
And they're all some good, smart people. You know, I hadn't seen a dummy yet. Now, they met one when they met me, you know, of course.
You're no dummy. You know, the worst, and it's not even the worst, but what I would say is, you know, you grew up in simpler times, but you've kept up with the technology. You're online, you're educating people and helping everyone. So welcome in, Silver Wolverine.
How you doing?
Good. How are you?
Hey, not too bad. So can I, what's the word I'm looking for? Take a opposite stand on what was just said about fiat being worthless. Not being worth anything.
No, I didn't say it's not worth anything, but it is. It's designed to devalue by approximately 2% per month.
Yeah,
but Silver Wolverine,
because because a lot of people say that, right? And the thing is that it's still our medium of exchange. We buy everything with it. So while most people don't like it and don't want it, and we'd rather have gold and silver, thing is that we need it.
That's right. It's a perfect, well, not perfect, but it's a great thing to use as a exchange, right? It's very easy to carry in your wallet and everything else. But now it's gone to digital as well. And
What I'm saying is not that it's worthless. It's not to us yet, that's for sure.
But it's worth less and less. It's worth less and less.
Yeah, it's about worth, what, about now 3 cents on the dollar when you get right down to it, somewhere in that neighborhood. But the other countries of the world, they're the ones that don't want it anymore. I mean, they're almost every day there's other countries saying, we don't want to be paying a dollar no more. We want it in Russian rubles or something.
Sure. And I think it was, if I'm not mistaken, Sal was talking about the BRICS and that, and he said it's BRICS. Whatever they do is not going to affect our dollar one bit. And I don't want to, you know, misquote what he was saying, but I mean, I tend to agree with it. I think the whole BRICS thing is completely overrated as far as it relates to our dollar.
Well, I have to disagree because I think that's where the world is going. You know, not, I haven't seen the dollar put up, if they would get to a, you know, something that's backing it up other than oil, you know, that, then I could see it, but I don't see, I just don't see how just oil backing the dollar is going to be as good as the precious metals.
I think, I don't think the United, well, I guess that could be a controversial topic, but I don't think the U.S. is going to allow it to happen. I don't think they're going to allow anybody else to have the main currency, so to speak.
Well, I think Russia's already working on that, them and China, with the ruble and the yuan, or however you say that. They pretty much, you know, put it out there. They are definitely challenging the U.S. on the money front. There's no doubt about it. Of course, there's a battle. You know, there's going to be a battle. But
yeah. I mean, we fight wars over that, right?
Yes. Yeah, that's what Iraq and Libya were about. I think, and that's an opinion again, but I'm just saying this. But yeah, to me, it just seems, you know, that if the whoever is in charge of all of this, you know, in the U.S., if they don't do something, I guess it's Biden, but I don't know. But if they don't do something to help back the dollar up, because we're already so far in debt with, you know, what, 30 some odd trillion or maybe more to China, and not just China, the rest of the world.
Right.
Then where else could it go? You know, it's.
Well, the thing is, the one thing I'd say to Americans is you got to look more globally, because pretty much every single country in the world is in debt. So like Ronnie, when you just said, you know, we're in debt to China, well, most of the debt is through government bonds, and all these countries are holding each other's central banks bonds. So they're all in debt. To me, there's already been a takeover of the world financially by the central banks. They already own pretty much everything.
Well, and I'm glad you brought that up, Jam, because that's what I think is going on right now. They're wresting control, as we knew the central banks before. They're taking the control has been slowly shifted out of those central banks as we knew them to the new breed of central banks, which is going to be precious metals backed. See, that's what I'm seeing. I mean,
No IQ says Jubilee. So yeah, like in some ways, this country owes this country. It's all crossed over like that.
Absolutely.
And in a lot of ways, it should be able to be X'd out. But I know there's lots of economists that'll say I'm crazy, and I'm surprised 79 didn't call me crazy yet.
And reserve currency was the word I was looking for that I was losing, but is any other country going to take over as the reserve currency? I don't know. I mean, it hasn't happened yet, and it's always been the speculation that it's going to happen. Will it? I don't know.
I think the most likely will be a gold back. Whoever goes to the gold backed currency, that will be the reserve currency, because in my opinion, gold is the reserve. It's performed better than the U.S. dollar, right?
Absolutely. Well, I understand that's where Russia's been for a while, and more or less China. They're not as much into the precious metal system yet as Russia is, but Russia's been there a while, and they all, you know, that's what formed the BRICS, is that they're all in it together. Some of them ain't as far ahead as the other ones are in it, but they're catching up. And there's more coming on every day.
Well, I'm glad you mentioned that because, well, as far as gold, because that was actually something that I was thinking about working on as far as the video is concerned, is while everybody's waiting for silver to hit $30, I mean, gold is just shooting the moon, right? I mean, it's hitting all-time highs, and silver is still $25 to $26 an ounce. Now, you can say that that's just paper price, but I mean, paper price is the measuring stick, and then you have the premiums.
Well, tell me something, Wolverine. Do you think silver might be artificially repressed by certain people? I mean, I don't know who, but I'm just asking a question.
I'm sure it is, but I think it's always going to be because it's an industrial metal. So, I mean, I don't think we have proof. I mean, a lot of people want to say JP Morgan. And I mean, and they've been convicted and all this of manipulation. You know, you can argue how much on what scale, but I think to a certain degree, the paper manipulation with silver is going to always be there because the industry needs silver to be lower. I mean, if silver went to $300 an ounce, which a lot of people speculate that, you know, or what they say it should be, $200, $300, do we want to live in that world where we got to pay a huge amount of money for everything because silver's so expensive, or where they have to find an alternative to silver to put into, you know, all these devices, cell phones and whatnot?
Yeah, and that was my point right there. Thank you for making that, because that is, and not only that, but the solar things on top of the houses, you know, they make those of silver. And so that's why I was asking if you thought maybe it was artificially repressed is because of all those things. And but gold, and I believe me, I'm not knocking gold. I think gold is a fabulous metal, but it's not used in as many things, so far as I know, as gold is. I mean, it's silver.
Right. But gold is a tier one asset, and the central banks and countries have a vested interest in the price of gold going up.
Gotcha. Yeah, I agree. And they all have a vested interest in keeping silver down, because of all the things we were just talking about. So, yeah, I definitely agree with you. You and Jim both are very smart on these things, which is great, you know, to talk to other people that are into this stuff like I am. And I just recently got into it, so you guys are, I'm sure, way ahead of me in it. That's why I asked so many questions, though, because I'm trying to, you know, prove what I know to myself, but also to learn.
Right. So, I mean, I'm not as bullish on silver as a lot of other people are, you know. I mean, I like it. I buy it. I buy mainly when it comes to silver. I buy mainly the collectible stuff and a lot less of the bullion. And then when it comes to stacking, I like to stack more of the gold.
I got you. And I understand that completely. That's the way I am with all of it. To me, I believe that it's not only going to be gold and silver, but it's also going to be silver, platinum, many others. You know,
copper. I really like copper and nickel too.
Absolutely, all those things.
I just wanted to bring this up for a second here, and then we'll bring it back. I just wanted to address this because we were talking earlier about, you know, how much debt the U.S. has.
Yeah.
And I just wanted to show that it's not just the U.S. So this is the U.S. debt clock, which can be found at usdebtclock.org. And right in here, if you can see my cursor in the top left, it says world debt clocks. There's also state debt clocks, but I wanted to show you world.
Yeah.
Just so you can see that the U.S. is not alone in this. There's already been a takeover of the world. So the US has 31.7 trillion in national debt, but China has 14. You know, Japan has 13, Germany 3 billion. India's got 3 trillion. Oh, yeah. France, India, Italy, Brazil, Canada, Argentina's got 607 million, but Australia's got a billion. Belgium, but you know, you can go through this and see it all. But the point is, everyone's in the same boat. Spain's got
no doubt. No doubt. And most of their economies, when you weigh it against, when you look at how much they owe compared to the U.S., our economy is so much, you know, larger. So it's only natural that the U.S. would carry more debt. But then you got to look back again. What are these people doing about it? Well, a lot of them, you know, like I said, are going to the precious metal backed system, which is, as far as I can see, it's the only option left. You know, you can't. What else are you going to base it on?
I think it's funny, Terry. You know, yes, 79 says stay away from silver. At the next one down says stay away from collectibles. So,
and my ticker at the bottom says this is not advice. Someone's got to put it in the chat. Here's my advice is ... Make up your own. So long as I got that ticker, you never thought what That's about right. me. So just so you know, Ronnie, if you ever see 79 in anyone else's chat, she's got a great sense of humor, and she'll be the one that says silver sucks. She likes gold, and I think she even likes cryptos.
Well, I'm very interested to hear why she thinks you should stay away from silver, though. I mean,
well, I'm pretty familiar with 79, and you know, going back many years, and it's the big part, and I don't want to speak for her. She can clearly speak for herself, but I mean, it all goes to the premiums, and silver has a lot of premiums on it. Some more than others. And we're not talking about collectibles. We're talking about bullion, rounds, bars. And then if you want to go silver eagles, huge premiums, right?
And Ronnie may not be familiar with that. He's just kind of getting into it. But the most popular bullion coin, which is the American Silver Eagle, also has just massive premiums on it the last, 2-3 years?
Well, man, I don't know. Yeah. The way I look at it, silver is kind of the poor man's gold, you know?
Yeah, yeah. So basically, like JM says, this is not financial advice. It's just a discussion. But the one thing that I would say about silver is, you know, when I first got into it back in 2016, I was going heavy. I mean, I was buying, you know, taking every bit of cash that I had and just putting it all into silver, buying. And then I had to sell some because I had a car insurance bill, you know. So that's why I speak a lot on my channel about not just putting all your money into silver and gold, but also having enough cash, fiat, to pay your bills, and not just pay your bills, but also have emergency, you know, money in case something else were to come up, that you don't have to sell your gold and silver. But the thing with silver is, if you do go heavy into silver and then you need to sell, there's a lot of premiums on it, and you're going to take a loss if you had to sell silver, you know, in the short term.
Yeah. So just for easy numbers for you, Ronnie, like, let's say silver's $25 when you look at the markets right now, you're probably going to be paying 30. Is that about right? For say a fairly.
Yeah, I just bought some yesterday. So yeah, that's right.
Okay. But so you go ask your coin shop or your dealer, if I come back and sell this to you tomorrow, what will you give me? And most of them will probably say, 25, even though you just paid 30. But my experience is, especially if you're a good customer, chances are they're going to pay you more than spot.
Yeah. And like I said, you know, this for me was, I'm just getting my feet wet, man. I'm still learning. You know, I admit I got a way to go, but I'm also not a total dumbass.
Oh, you'll pick it up. I've been studying it for the last couple of years, and like, I know I'm still near the bottom of the learning curve, but
definitely there for me. Yeah. But I don't want to just be in silver. I want other things too. Then the first time I bought it was, you know, all in the 1 ounce coins. This time I got them in smaller coins and, you know, things. So if I had to, if it was an emergency, you know, I could more easily buy things. I mean, I don't want to give $30 for a loaf of bread if I don't have to. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah. Yeah. I still think it's definitely a great idea to have some, but like Silver Wolverine is saying, you know, some of the people out there are rah, rah, rah. I'm all in on silver. Let's break the Fed. This, that. They're known as silver pumpers, right? And that's a dangerous thing to do. And that's where you get people that get soured out because they're like, oh, I thought you said silver was a great thing. And then it drops 20 or 30%, which it absolutely can at any time.
Oh, yeah. I totally agree. And that's why I was saying a while ago, you know, in the chat that I'm in it for the long term. You know, I didn't get in for a week or two. It's going to be a long term thing for me. And it could go down to nothing, you know, but so could basically anything else. So it's more unlikely for gold or whatever.
Yeah, because I mean, if you look back at like 2008 through 2000 and let's say 11, where silver went up to, you know, near $50 an ounce US dollars. And then in 2017 fell back down to 15 and it was there for a year and a half. And then gold, on the same note, gold went up to, I think it was somewhere just below 1900 and then fell down to $1,100 for quite a while. Mm-hmm. So you never know where these markets are going to go.
Yeah. And so who was it in here? I just switched to a different tab, said, you know, you got to diversify. And that's it. You just, a lot of people, they'll max out their credit cards. They go all in on it. And then, oh, I need a new car. Or, oh, this happens. And they've deployed all their cash. And that's not diversifying.
Well, I heard that. Well, yeah, and y'all tell me where you stand on this. But to me, I kind of see us going to where, remember how it was when we went into Iraq and their money all of a sudden became worthless? It was literally floating in the streets, blowing down the streets. Nobody would even stop to pick it up.
Yep, Venezuela.
Yeah, so that's kind of where I see the money here going if something is not done, you know, to balance it out.
Yep.
And I know that they're trying, you know, with the at least I heard here a while back, or read a while back, that they're trying to go to a digital back system, a precious metal back system. But to do that, from what I understood, they want to track everything you do with it. Now this is a digital thing, of course.
Yeah.
But
yeah. Well, they definitely want to do that.
Yeah.
They definitely want people tracked. So I'm just going to play this, these two things here, which are in the spirit of what we're talking about.
Say that silver is crashing.
Trying to tell us there, JM.
I did that video, was it maybe approximately a year ago? And it was when silver was getting smashed. I also have a couple videos where I took a hammer to silver to reenact it getting smashed. But I don't know, it seems fairly resilient to me. It's definitely had a nice run in the last couple months. And so that's another reason I'm really holding off on making any purchases right now.
Yeah, and you know, and I believe me, I understand anybody's point of view on where they buy it, if they have a good reason for not buying it or whatever. You know, that's totally up to the individual on how they feel about the money situation in general, how much money they've got, and so many other things.
Yeah. The place you're going to run into problems is when people say, oh, you know, silver's going to the moon, and people buy based on that. And you know, that's wrong. Nobody can tell. It might go way up. It might go way down. But in the long run, I'm definitely betting on it that it's going to do better than the currencies. So I'd rather have, you know, let's call it cash under the bed saved in metal than in actual cash.
But that being said, you and me both, JM, you and me both.
But you still got to have that cash reserve. Like a financial advisor that's got their certified financial planner designation or whatever the designation is that they get these days will tell you, you should have at least 3 months worth of cash on hand. Mm-hmm. Now they'll probably say in the bank, but to me, I'm good with 2 months worth of cash in the bank and then a couple months worth in cash and then
build up. Not with the trouble the banks have been in here lately, man. It's hard for me to trust them now. You know, maybe y'all have a different opinion, but I mean, I have very serious doubts about banks.
I was actually thinking about doing something on that too, a video. I haven't had a problem with a bank. You know, a lot of people talk about how they can't get cash out of the bank and all this. I've never had that problem.
I've not either, but I've heard lots of stories.
Yeah, me too. I've not had the problem myself, except for when I went up to pay for my, I just bought a travel trailer, Wolverine. And when I went up to get the money to pay for it, they didn't have the money there that I needed to pay for it. And so the only thing they could do, right then was to give a cashier's check. So that's what we did. And I almost asked them, well, how come y'all didn't get the money in your bank? It was crossing my mind.
One thing that I'll say about that, because I do know some people who work for some banks, and the one thing about a bank is you can get out, you can take out as much money as you want. The problem is, over a certain amount, they have to order it because they don't keep it in the bank. So I do know that there's been people who, you know, walked into a bank and requested, let's say, $30,000. They were able to get that $30,000, but it took a couple of days because they have to order it because they don't keep it in the branch.
Right. And they, like, let's say you've got $1 million in your checking account, Ronnie, and you go in one day and you say, I want $500,000, right? Mm-hmm. In cash. Obviously, they're not going to have that. And if my understanding is there's only like 10% of cash in circulation to cover everything that's out there, including digital, right? Yeah. But what they will do is they give you like a money order. I'm not sure what it's called in the States, like a money order or a draft or a certified check to pretty much any institution or person that you want. So you could say, okay, $100,000 to this lawyer and $100,000 to my friend and whatever. And you can get it out almost immediately that way.
Yeah, and I was studying up on this here a month or two ago, and I probably got some of this wrong again, but what I was reading then and what they were saying was the reason that the banks can't get, you know, a certain amount of money now like they did a year or two ago, whenever, is because what they would do is, I mean, like I say, you wanted to build a home, it's going to cost $350,000, and you had to pay so much to the contractor to get it started. Well, what they would normally do is, tell them, we'll have your money this afternoon or tomorrow. And then they would call the Federal Reserve Bank in their area and order a certain amount of money, and they would have it, you know, the next day or whatever. But according to what I was reading, they said they can't do that anymore because the banks and the reserve banks, and, you know, they have one in each area, state, or however it works, that they normally don't have that money now. For whatever reason, I mean, maybe they've overprinted, maybe they're not printing anymore. I don't know, but I'm just saying that was the reasoning that I read then.
Well, digital is so much more convenient, so I can see absolute application for digital currencies. And in fact, in my opinion, we already do have a digital currency. You know, every time you use your debit card or your credit card, that's digital U.S. dollars.
Oh, absolutely. I totally agree.
I don't see why we need another one unless it's that one's already seen the best of its days.
I totally agree. That's one reason the banks don't carry as much money as they used to also is because of that debit card. They just you know, the money, it's not, the money is not really there. It's just, it's there on paper.
Yeah, it's a digital one, and not even on paper in most cases. It's just a digital entry.
Absolutely.
Well, one reason is also because they it's for security purposes too, where they're not allowed to have that. They're only allowed to have a certain amount in the branches because of so they don't get robbed.
Fair enough.
Yep, I can see that too. But no, there's some of the stuff that I'm truly trying to nail down in my own mind. And, you know, although we do talk a lot about it, and I offer the best opinion that I can, my opinion is not from a banker's point of view, let's say, or a financial advisor's point of view whatsoever. I'm just stating my views on it.
Mm-hmm.
And that. And they're not necessarily right, you know, so I'm just.
Yep, it's tough to know. So what I'm going to do right now is just grab myself a quick refill, and I'm going to play, not this, I'm going to play something else. And then you guys can feel free to chat or just hang out and wait. I'll be back in like 2 minutes.
All right.
Okay.
So Wolverine, how long you been into this kind of stuff?
Since about 2015.
2015.
Oh, I mean, a little bit before that, but not much. And then I started my channel in 2016.
Okay, I got you. Well, I'm going to have to subscribe to you. Let me get my phone out here. I'll probably blow everybody up before I can get it turned down, but I want to subscribe to you while we're here. All right, let's see here. This is it. All right, let's see here. Well, I don't see anything. Did you say anything? There you are. Okay, never mind. I got you. All right, I got you. I'm subscribed to you, bro. So.
Thanks. Yeah, I.
I'm all about learning, you know. And my thing is, I like to learn all points of view. You know, not just one, not just one on the left, one on the right, but I like to learn in the middle and everywhere else.
Yeah. Now on my channel, I talk a lot about high premium stuff because it's a lot about. Investment collectibles. So, but I just did a video yesterday about American Silver Eagles, the bullion coins, and their high premiums. Because they're extremely high premium right now. I don't know. Have you bought any American Silver Eagles coins?
No, not yet.
Oh, okay. Yeah, they're very high priced right now.
What do they go for?
So basically the average right now for an ounce of silver for one coin is like 40, it's like a little over $40.
Dang.
Yeah.
You know, back when I was.
But you can buy like maple leaves for, I haven't looked at those prices, but they're, let me see how much they are, but they're much cheaper. I haven't looked at them in a while.
Hey, Silver Wolverine, if if you know how to do the share screen there, if there's anything you pull up that you want to share, I'll put it up.
Yeah, see, right now, a maple leaf over at Monument Metals is $31.86, so about $10 cheaper for a maple leaf than it is a Silver Eagle. $10, that's huge. That's a lot of money, $10 for an ounce.
What year are let's say the maple leaves and the silver eagles, what year are they made in? Are the different years? Are they all the same?
2023 this year.
Okay, so they're not very old. I got you. Okay. I mean, they're not old at all.
And then a silver eagle, 2023 silver eagle is $41.36, so almost exactly $10 cheaper for that maple leaf.
Yeah. And here's another thing that I'm looking at that I don't know if y'all know or not, is that Texas, which is where I live, is going to the precious money metal back system on September 1st of this year. The law has already been passed, so we're just waiting until September the 1st. And so that's another reason why I only bought this little dab of silver to begin with. And so I bought some more, but I'm going to get other stuff too, you know, because I don't think anyone understands how the law is going to work here in Texas, you know, right now, until it all goes into effect. Then we kind of have to learn on the go.
Well, which law is that?
I'm sorry?
Which law are you referring to?
The law that is where the money is, precious money back system, precious metal back money system is going to affect here in Texas on September 1st.
Yeah, that bill was passed, right?
Yes, sir.
So Texas is going to go on to its own Texas currency, which will be backed by precious metals.
Yes, sir. I don't fully understand the law. A big chap did put it up here a couple of weeks ago, you know, while we was on air and showed it and all. But I don't think anyone truly understands it yet, you know, how it's all going to be done. Now, I know I certainly don't, but I'm just saying that it just seems to me, and I know everybody, you guys probably have a different opinion, and that's great because I ain't saying much of that. But it seems to me like, Texas may be the first state that goes, which they are, and then, you know, pull other states along with it, because Texas, other than California, is the biggest economy in the country. So,
and here, what I've pulled up actually is saying it's not just generically precious metals, but it's going to be gold-backed. It'll be backed by gold. Texas
gold. It's gold only. Is that what you're saying, JM?
Yeah, but still a digital currency.
Oh shit! Well, I didn't know it was digital. So that's what I'm saying. I don't understand how it's going to work yet, and I definitely don't. It may be more trouble than what we got now.
Right. It could be a better mousetrap. I'll share the screen here that I've got on it. Let's see if you can see that.
It's just still buffering.
It'll come up in a minute. I got like 30 tabs over.
Yeah.
Anyway, Jam, thanks for having me on. I actually have to run. But it was a good chat. Good talking with you guys.
Good talking to you, Wolverine. Have a good
one. Yeah, you too. This is where it's showing it here. Texas House Committee is taking the first steps in the discussion of a bill that creates the digital currency 100% backed by gold. 5 days ago.
And from the way I understand it, goes into effect September the 1st of this year. Does it say that anywhere? I know a chap pulled the bill up a couple of weeks ago, but
yeah, that's most I've seen. Let's just see what it says.
Okay.
What is the new gold-backed digital currency? The gold-backed digital tokens will be a form of electronic. No, that's not it.
It says backed by Zimbabwe's gold reserves.
Yeah, so. Yeah, that was a bad link there. March 10, 2020, bills were introduced in the Texas Senate and House to create a state-issued gold-backed digital currency. Here, we'll see what this says. Texas House advances it. And Silver Wolverine, if you're still listening, I think Thanks for stopping by and coming up.
Yeah, we didn't read it that night. I wish we had have. We was talking about so many other things, you know, when Chap pulled it up. I mean, I was telling about it, but then he pulled it up. But we didn't read the thing. I meant to go back and read it, but I never have.
Yep. Okay. Well, this is giving me a month.
It's the what, Jam?
Which is tomorrow. We're interested in that. Texas House Advances Gold Back Digital. Can you hear me?
Yeah. The way I understood it, it was already passed and will go into effect September the 1st. I mean, that's not only what I've seen many other people talking about it, you know, and that's why I feel, you know, pretty safe in saying that it goes into effect September the 1st. Well, that's what it said the night that Chap pulled it up, too. But I don't know how he found it, so, or where he went to. It might have been on... might not have been on Google. It might have been on another one, but I don't know.
Yeah.
But to me, it just...
I'm just what still I'm looking saying. Here to see.
Yeah, go ahead. Don't mean to interrupt you there, bro.
What was the date? September?
Yeah, it's supposed to go into effect September the 1st.
That'd be good if we actually get this and then we can review it. Because I know you get busy on the chats there. Okay. Yeah. Two Texas lawmakers propose a gold-backed state currency. Bills state that a fractional equivalent amount of physical gold would back the proposed digital currency. Although neither of the bills have been passed or presented for a vote, both state that this act will take effect September 1st, 2023.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's what I've read in many places, not just, and I haven't read the bill itself, but I have saw in many places since I first saw it at all that it does go into effect September the 1st. Now, confirming I don't know if these that. People have a connection or what, you know. I'm just,
yeah, well, it says two Texas lawmakers have proposed it. And the bills state they're fractional equivalent. So that means it wouldn't be a one-to-one, right? Anything that's fractional means there's leverage. Just like our banking system is fractional, right? You deposit a dollar, and that gives them the ability to lend out like 10 or whatever the case may be. So a fractional equivalent, that's the first red flag there for me. Back to the proposal. And then digital currency, that's the second red flag. So... honestly, while it sounds good, it looks like a mousetrap to me.
And it may very well be. But the thing of it is that I saw other articles stating that the way they've done it is there's not going to be what we know as banks now. It's going to be more or less like just a place you can put your money, you know, that it's safe and only you have control of.
Yeah.
Now, again, I don't know how true any of this is. You know, it's just what I've been reading. So,
yeah.
Well, there's Mr. Charlie Cabal. And how are you doing, Charlie?
And so, anyone that doesn't know, Charlie is a fantastic musician. And Jamie is one of the people I know from the precious metals community. He frequently comes on to Salivate Metals channel, and he's definitely a fun guy. Good sense of humor, and Charlie's got a fantastic sense of humor too.
Oh, Charlie's wicked, man. I'm here to tell you. I don't know Jamie yet, but Charlie's I love Charlie, man. He's a great guy.
And I would actually feature one of his songs, but that he's done here for the people. But the problem is, if I share it from my screen, I have to do it in low quality or it'll buffer, and I don't want to. You know, put any of his content out there that's not up to par. on my end.
I bet Charlie wouldn't care. I'm just playing. But
well, you know, it's interesting that you say that, because in one of my previous live streams, he said, yeah, sure, go ahead. And I think I even had him put the link in. And I played it, and sure enough, it was buffering pretty bad.
Yeah, you know, Steve and I have done an interview with Charlie 2 times, JM. And okay. Both times, that's when you said it was buffering, that reminded me. Both times, I forgot now. One time he lost his voice, and the other time his computer, if I remember correctly, was acting up. And I thought, well, it's just our luck, you know. We get him on it both times, and something goes wrong, you know. But he knows, Charlie knows what I'm talking about. He's a fantastic guy. Even if you don't talk about music, you know, he's got a million stories.
Yeah.
Charlie's great.
Yeah, and actually, I remember being on the one live stream. Maybe it was Steve's. I think Charlie was having a glass of wine.
Yeah, it was. It
happened to be at the same time.
Yeah, I know one of them is on mine. I'm not sure about the other one. And one of them is probably on Steve's, and one of them on mine. I don't remember. But anyway, I had a heck of a good time with Charlie. There's no doubt about it.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
So good to see you, Charlie. Now, I tell you, JM, I don't know if you know it or not, but I got a new computer day before yesterday.
Yep.
And so last night, were you in the chat last night? I don't remember.
A little bit.
Okay.
Yeah. I went to bed early last night, but I was there for like maybe 40 minutes.
Okay. Well, I
saw a couple channels actually.
You know, I don't know if it was, I don't think it was my computer, but all throughout the show, every time I would go to talk about some of these touchy subjects, you know,
yep.
my computer or the internet, the power, you know, that is broadcasting by whatever would go down every time. And I thought, well, we all wondered what in the devil was going on, because people, you know, I was roboting, people couldn't hear me.
Yep.
I don't know if it was being done intentionally. I'm not saying it was. I'm saying I don't know.
You know, the beginning of this stream, I recommend everybody don't go back to the beginning of it, because the first 5 minutes was an absolute cluster.
Was yours doing the same thing?
Well, part of it was my fault. I had the YouTube open in another tab, so I kept getting that echo. I forgot to shut that off.
Uh-oh.
And then when I played, you know, those brands, like I had the silver crashing earlier and all that sort of thing.
Yeah.
It kept playing and playing. It was like it was on repeat. But it wasn't on repeat.
So it was like it was on a loop?
Yeah. So the first 5 minutes of it was me just troubleshooting, trying to get the thing going properly. But, hey, Charlie, just because I don't think you know 79 and Jamie and NoIQ, if you do want to pop a link in the chat here to one of your videos, or even better, to your channel, so these people can subscribe, I'll play any of your videos that you like.
79, I got you there, JM.
It was a lot worse. Like right now, I think the audio is okay. Let's see here. I think the video's okay. But yeah, it was pretty rough. Which is fine. And I would have wound this down earlier, but my friend Ronnie came up here, and so we had a good chat. Silver Wolverine was up here too.
We did. We had a good chat today.
Silver Wolverine will always get you thinking. Because it's very rare that he's on the mainstream narrative or talking about the same thing. He's got his own opinions, and it's so. I've had a few debates with him, and it's always good to get different perspectives from people that have, you know.
Oh, it definitely is, and that's exactly it. You know, Jam, you wouldn't believe how many times I've got criticized here in the past couple of months, you know, for you know, debating somebody or having a different opinion than this other person. It's, for me anyway, it's never about, you know, not being friends. It's just about that one little, I mean, there might be 1% that we don't agree with each other on. You know, so that's the 1% we debate. But I've gotten kind of hammered here the past couple of months, you know, because of my opinions and stating them. You know, I've never mean to anybody or disrespectful. But people, you know, some people take it, not everybody, of course, but thank God, but somehow. But it's all it is, you know, it's just a debate and a debate over an opinion.
Yeah. But the tension can happen when you strongly believe something and you become passionate about it, and someone has a different opinion and they believe it strongly and they're passionate about it, and you start having a discussion about it.
Absolutely. Right? Well, I know that you and I don't have the same opinions on everything, but we're still very good friends, you know, and I think we could debate and not have a problem at all.
Yep.
Well, it don't mean you're an enemy at all.
Well, and that's one of the things with you, Ronnie, is I don't feel that you've got an overly inflated ego, you know. So humility is really important when, you know, when someone makes a mistake or when they're wrong, to be able to admit it is a fantastic quality, you know.
Absolutely. I don't think I've got an ego at all. Maybe I do, but I try not to have one.
Just about saying it. But that's because I know you're one of the best singers out there.
Now, as far as singing goes, I'm probably the best. Yep. But singing, I stink.
Right on. Well, Charlie did not put a link in here. He might be looking it up, or he may just be saying, no, I don't want you to play it if it's not good.
Either that or he dozed off. I don't know which.
Yeah. He should at least put his channel link in there.
You know what, Jim? I just now thought, if I ever do sing again, I think I'm going to sing. Have you ever heard the song by Mac Davis, "Oh Lord, It's Hard to Be Humble"?
I definitely remember the chorus, and I've definitely heard it. Yep.
I think that's one I'm going to do.
When I'm perfect in so many ways?
Yeah.
That would be a good one.
And to do that, though, would be the opposite of what I think I am, you know. I mean, what he's saying in the song is he is definitely not humble.
Yeah.
But I hadn't thought of that until we got on the subject of there being humble or no ego. And plus, I seen the message down there from, I'm not sure how you say that, no EQ?
It's no IQ.
No IQ. Okay. All right. Says I'm humiliated all the time, and it's hard to be humble when you're perfect in every way. Can't wait to look in the mirror, cause I get better looking each day.
Right on. Look, you don't even need any music. Acapella is perfect.
Oh man.
Hey, Liquid Electrum, how's it going? Good to see you.
Definitely. How you doing, Liquid?
I hope you didn't watch the beginning of this. In fact, I might even trim it out after the fact. That's how bad it was.
Do you edit all yours, JM, or how do you?
No. Like the most of the long form videos that I do, I edit those. You know, just for special effects and stuff like that. But most of my live streams, I don't. There's one or two copyright claims where I had to cut that part out. So I did that, but I don't like to, because when you edit them after the fact on a live stream, it deletes the comment section. So people can't see the comments after.
Oh, so I didn't know that. I tried to edit one time, but that was with the editing thing that, I guess YouTube or StreamYard is, whichever one it is. I couldn't even come close to figuring it out. I thought, well, I had no idea. I'd have deleted the whole video if I'd have tried.
Yeah.
So I hadn't messed with it since.
It's tough. I'm trying to remember if StreamYard has an editing feature. It must, but just directly through YouTube is where I've done. That's where you can add music, like through the audio library.
Well, see, you're smarter than I am, though. I couldn't figure it out, which I didn't try very long either, because it was just it's two lines that came up, and I couldn't see what it was what it was saying that it was going to edit. I needed somebody there to guide me through it.
Okay, you know what you do, Ronnie, is go onto YouTube, and in the search type, you might want to write it down. YouTube video editor tutorial.
Oh, I remember that. I didn't know they had one.
Yeah, you can put almost anything into the search in YouTube and it'll come up with stuff. Sometimes it's not relevant, or it'll send you down the wrong path, but usually YouTube tries to serve you the video that's most appropriate to what you put into the search. But yeah, tutorials are great for almost anything.
I did find one time. I don't even know how I did it, but I blocked somebody that was a good friend of mine. This has been a while back, a couple of years ago. I mean, I was just getting started on YouTube, and however I blocked him, I don't know, but I was trying to find out how to unblock him. And so I asked another guy on YouTube on the chat, and he said, well, go look it up for yourself. He said, I don't have, but I ain't gonna tell you. I said, well, thank you very much. That's what I'll do. So I did. And I don't remember how I did it, but it wasn't hard to do at all. Once I seen what it was.
Yeah. A lot of people that, put the time in and they study whatever the subject is. When someone comes along and they're like, hey, can you tell me how to do this? They won't tell you, they're not helpful, because just like what that guy said to you, right? He's like, figure it out yourself.
Yeah. Very rude. I thank him for now, but at the time, I got to admit, it pissed me off, because he was so rude about it.
Yep.
But I would thank him now because it helped me out.
That's what kids are doing now. Like, you see kids walking down the street and their eyes are not watching out for telephone posts and what they're walking on. They're glued to the screen. A lot of that is, they're looking things up. They're checking stuff out online. So the answer to almost every question is there, except for the question. I think if you put into Google, why does 79, Terry 79, block lots of people? It could actually crash the entire internet.
That bad, huh? Or good.
I don't think it'll be able to figure it out.
Yeah, I agree. I heard I've seen a video on the gunfire there. It was on a bridge, Reynosa, and somewhere. I mean, it sounded like open war. Oh, Miss Karen, good to see you.
Hey, Karen. What was this one? Here, I missed this comment. Sorry, guys. I'm still new to this.
That's one they're talking about. I would think it's the one there on the bridge. It's two names. The last one was Reynosa. I don't remember first, but there was a lot of gunfire. It sounded like a civil war had broke out or something. I mean, it was machine gun fire.
I heard people talking about that a week or so ago, that there was going to be they were lifting the border restrictions. So pretty much anyone could come in, like, just come on in.
That's what is supposed to happen tomorrow. But I saw today, and I don't know how true the report is, but that Biden had decided to renew Title 42. We'll see if that's actually true or not, but I'm just saying that's what I read right before I come on here.
Okay. That's crazy.
It is. I hope he renewed it, man. You got to ask yourself, why are they letting so many people cross the border? I don't know. I mean, I think I know, but I ain't going to repeat it here. I mean, it's kind of easy to, it can only be for a couple of reasons.
Well, I saw the one headline there too that said, what was it? There was something like 20,000 migrant children that had crossed the southern border that are now just missing.
I think there's more than that, but that's plenty, way too much. Yeah, I mean, they go missing. They had supposedly had no idea where they went. I mean, you know, they know where these kids are. They, of course, they're going to say they don't know, but they know. And I think you know what I'm talking about, Jan. Like I said, I'm not going to say it here, but.
Yeah, I hear you.
Yeah, and in Texas, I'm sorry.
That's okay, Ronnie. No worries.
I was going to say Texas sent a lot of their supposedly specially trained troops down there to deal with this border thing tomorrow, too. But the thing is, we've had Texas itself has had National Guard members on the border now for about a year. And there's a guy that goes down there every day and films it. Oscar Blue, I think is his name. And he showed them literally helping people across the river. So they're not there to help us. They're there to help them get across the river.
Gotcha.
Oh, exactly, Miss Karen. Yep. Now, from what I hear, they have been arresting a lot. I mean, loads of Chinese coming across the border.
The southern border.
Yep. And it's definitely an invasion. You know, here's a wild thing, JM, and I was reading this or whatever a couple of years ago, or maybe whatever it was, but there was a judge in Texas that they were interviewing him about the border and everything. He said, well, the thing is that the state of Texas has declared an emergency. He said, once that is done, all the governor has to, he's got all the authority he needs. All he has to do is put all these people on a plane or whatever and take them right back, you know, to where they came from. Now, not necessarily the plane, but he was just using that as an example.
Yep.
And the point is, he's not doing anything. You know, he's busing them to other places in the country. Yeah, but they're still in the country. And all of, now the state has asked other states to help out, you know, with the busing and the return and all that, and trying to get that. As a matter of fact, I know Florida and a couple other states did. I think Oklahoma sent some of their highway patrolmen and police officers down to help there for several months, but they realized that what they were actually doing was helping get across the border instead of making them stay in, you know, Mexico. And so they just brought their enforcement officers back home.
You know, in the old days, they had what they called a Trojan horse.
Uh-huh.
Where it was actually disguised as a gift.
Yeah. But it was
the furthest thing from a gift. Now they don't even bother with disguising it. They just walk right in.
Absolutely. And I'm telling you, they're walking in, swimming in, rowing in, flying in. Well, I know you've heard about where they, you know, how the Afghani people, they flew in here several months back.
Right. Yeah.
So it's not just Mexicans and people from South America. It's from all over the world.
Yeah.
They are diluting our country so much. They're taking away our identity. They're taking away everything.
It really is a shame, too. Like, I used to look at the United States of America as a bastion of freedom. You know, like, it's the ultimate place to go. But, like, now here in Canada, it's not a whole lot better, but, you know.
No, you're absolutely right. Well, America, you know, was always called the melting pot for a reason. That was because people that wanted to come here, you know, did it legally, and they could, you know, they could meld in with the rest of the population and take on the values, you know, that we had, and forget the values that they left behind.
That's right.
But the people that are coming here now are not coming here to meld in with us. They're coming here wanting us to meld in with them. They don't really want to be part of the country. They just want what the country has to offer and not offer anything back.
Yeah. Yeah. It's a matter of taking rather than giving. And the only thing that they're giving is demands.
Absolutely. They come over, and there is proof of this where they, and I don't know how many, I mean, there's been thousands, if not hundreds of thousands. When they come over here, they're given money to rent hotel and motel rooms. And I don't mean just any old motel room or hotel room, but I mean nice hotels. They're given food stamps. They're basically, you know, everything. They're given a cell phone. They're given everything on our dime. I mean, we're, of course, we're the ones that's going to have to pay for it. So.
Yep. And, it, you know, like I do feel bad for people in the third world countries and that people that don't have the opportunity. And they want to go to a better place, but there's a reason that it's a better place. And that's because it was built on a strong foundation.
And so a constitution, coming in, absolutely.
Coming in and knocking down the foundation should not be invited. Right?
Yeah,
that should be declined.
That's exactly right. It's kind of like, you know, people that move from wherever to Florida or Texas, wherever, you know, because of the you know, the political climate, because everything is, you know, pretty good in those states. But then when they get there, they want to keep doing the things they did in their states. And all it does is finally, it's going to destroy that state too, and you got no place left to go to. That's exactly what's happened to this whole country.
Yep.
By all these people coming over.
Yep. And I'm sure, you know, there's good people. I'm sure there's good people that are coming over. But if you're good people, come through the legal prescribed ways. Don't be sneakity sneaking in.
Exactly. Right? Come through the front door. Don't sneak in the back door.
Beautiful.
Or window.
Well said.
That's all they got to do, but they don't want to take that time. And, you know, the way we've been handling the border, they don't have to. All they got to do is wait until the cartels get under the border. And believe me now, these people that are coming over here, and I'm talking about little ones that are being raped and everything else by these cartel members, all the way up. So, I mean, all the way up through Mexico and everything. So, man, it's a really sad situation in many, many ways. Yeah. These people, a lot of them are paying with their very lives and the lives of their children. It's heartbreaking, you know, when you stop to think about it, what is actually happening. And it's mainly focused on our country.
Yeah.
It just seems to me, Jay, I'm like they are literally out to destroy our country.
I think they've been at it for a long time, and they're just relentless.
Oh, they have definitely been at it for a long time, but now they put it into high gear. They're really after us. Yeah, I definitely think, Electrum, that this is my own way of looking at it. I don't say that could keep from being a war sooner or later, you know, with these cartels and everything. There's almost got to be. I mean, between, you know, the people, and I ain't necessarily saying by our military, I'm saying by the people of this country, because there's going to have to come a point when people in this country will no longer take, and not just Texans or people from Arizona or New Mexico or California, but people in the country, once they see how this is affecting their life and their loved ones, are going to be forced to stand up somewhere along the way and to take back, or at least try to take back, what has been taken from us. Either it's all going to be taken and it's going to be over with.
Yeah. And that's tough too. Like, I'm worried what's going to happen, you know, like say they start coming in and squatting on people's lands, right?
Mm-hmm. They already are.
So you remove them yourself, then the authorities come and say, oh, well, you're taking the law into your own hand, and then they throw, you know, they charge you or arrest you.
They're already doing it in Texas, do you? That's been happening. You can't even pull a gun on one up now, even if they're on your land, threatened to break into your house, they will arrest you if you pull a gun on them. They've done it. and they let the lawbreaker go. It hadn't been on the news very much, but you go to these guys that I was telling about a while ago, and they will tell you exactly what's happening. But they don't put it on the news. I wonder why.
Yeah. Or if they do, it's a softened up story about it.
Yeah, there were two women here about a year ago, both of them on the border, and they told the county name, but I don't remember which one it was now. And one of them was, I think she was 80, either 74 or 84 years old. They had broken into her home. It was three men. The way I remember it, there was three men. And, you know, like I said, she's an old woman. She didn't have a weapon or anything. No, I take that back. She did have a weapon. Yep. But they took the weapon away from her, beat her face in with the weapon, raped her, and more or less left her there for dead. She didn't die, but they beat her up something terrible. You know, caved her bones in on her face and the orbital things with your eye, you know?
Yep.
Over the bones. And another lady had been at work. I don't know. I don't remember how she was, but she had been at work. She comes home from work, and there's a woman sitting at her kitchen table, had prepared her own dinner or whatever, you know, was sitting there at the table, you know, had already ate and everything, was sitting on the table at the table talking on the telephone. And so the woman that owns the house walked in and said, "What are you doing?" And the illegal alien looked at her and said, "It ain't none of your business." And so the woman that owns the place turns around and goes and, you know, gets a pistol.
Yep.
And comes back and tells her to get the hell out of her house. Well, of course, the woman left that was there illegally. She left the house. But then they came out and arrested the woman that pulled a gun on her, you know, because, I mean, she was defending not only her life, but her property and everything, you know. And Texas has always been known. It's not called stand your ground, but it's basically the same thing.
Yep. Don't mess with Texas.
Yeah, but it's plain now that you can mess with Texas all you want to if you're from south of the border or any other country, really.
Well, I think that you're doing a good job, Ronnie, of bringing the information to people and letting them, decide what to do with it. And I like how you're tactful with it, but you know, at some point I think another platform is going to be better, because that way you don't have to keep
self-censoring. I heard that, man. I hate to do that too, you know, because you miss so much of the, I mean, like last night, for instance, JM, there were close to 200 views when I took it down.
Yep.
And I don't want to take them down, but if I don't, I know what's going to happen. So yep. I do take them down. But the thing of it is, you know, it's a slow build. You know, I know it's going to take a long time to get where I really want it to go, where people will know about it, you know, and actually come and listen.
Yep.
And be able to stay the whole time. But it's going to take a while to get there. And in the meantime, I won't have a... But I am on Rumble. But Rumble is just... Man, it's a messed up platform, I'll put it like that. Well, LSP, what's going on, bro?
Hey, LSP. Greetings. I'm blessed to have Ronnie up here. Speaking of which, Ronnie, I think you should probably post your link again. Or I can post it for you. Anyone that wants to get more information from Ronnie, he's a very knowledgeable guy and great person to keep up with the news with, should definitely subscribe to his channel and Big Chop too.
Exactly. I would definitely appreciate it, man. Thank you, JM, for mentioning that, bro.
Yep.
Yeah, and the... Oh, go ahead. I'm sorry.
Title 42 expires tomorrow.
Yep. And that's what we was talking about a minute ago, LSP. And I was telling JM earlier, I heard it right before I come on here, and I don't know how true it is, but I did hear that Biden has extended Title 42. I don't know if that's true, but I'm just saying that's what I heard before I come on. JM. I'm just passing along so if people can go look if they want to, but
yep.
I don't know. No, thank you, LSP. Appreciate that, bro.
Awesome. LSP. Yeah, and so then for anyone here that doesn't know, Ronnie York's friend for doing the live streams and the information is a Big Chap. And so they'll tend to alternate channels because I think partly because StreamYard, you only get so many hours that are on the free subscription.
Yeah.
But both Ronnie's and Big Chap's channel should be subscribed to if you like this sort of thing.
Yeah, and I'll be the first one to say that my channel is not for everybody. I mean, that's for sure. You know, it just depends on what I call it is thinking outside the box. You know, that's what I try to do, along with a lot of, you know, news that can't be mistaken. But most of my way of thinking is to think outside the box, you know. Now, I know what the general perception of everything is, so, you know, I try to do it the other way and let people go look for themselves, whatever it is, you know, that they think is crap or they think is real or whatever.
Yeah.
And Big Chap's a heck of a guy, too. I mean, there's no doubt.
I do try to keep it real on my channel. I haven't got any strikes yet, and I kind of want to keep it that way.
Don't blame me.
And I haven't actually had to take any streams down, but for anyone in the audience here that doesn't know, when you go to Ronnie and Big Chap's live stream, they'll be less censored than on my channel. And then after the show, they just take the whole show down so that it doesn't cause any issues.
Absolutely. That's absolutely right, JM. I know I left one up, and I don't know, I was tired that night, and I just forgot to take it down when we went off. And I thought about it the next afternoon about 2 o'clock. And by then I'd already gotten a strike.
Yep.
On the channel I'm on now. So.
And so for anyone that knows Ronnie, he gets his channel taken down more than most people. So he keeps having backup channels.
Absolutely. I've lost 4 so far.
So there's a clear proof that Ronnie is more courageous than JM.
Well, I don't know if it's more courageous. I you know, to me, JM, and I'm being totally honest here, man. I just feel like that there is something that's driving me, you know, to get this information out. And I've just got to do it, you know, whatever the cost may be.
Yeah.
That's just the way I feel. It's not that I don't know if it's courageous or not. Maybe it is, but
it could also be viewed as a test pilot too, right? You never know if it's going to get taken down until you try.
That's right.
Or until you push the limit.
That's right. No, the first, many of my first ones, you know, didn't get taken down. And so I didn't even get a strike. So I thought, well, maybe it's, and they did change some of their policies, you know, to allow more, but, you know, more things to be said. And so that's basically the things I was saying there for a long time. And I woke up one morning and 2 channels were gone. I don't know what we said on those channels because I didn't get an email. I didn't get anything, not a kiss goodbye. I mean, nothing, man. They were just gone. So I don't know what happened. I appreciate you guys subbing. Electrum and who else was it? So somebody else subscribed. Maybe that was who I saw. I don't remember now, but anyway, thank you, Liquid.
Yep, Liquid Electrum's definitely got you. And I know Liquid Electrum from the precious metals community as well. And I don't know, let's ask you a trivia question. Can you define the word electrum, Ronnie?
I don't think I can.
I have a tough time with it too, but I know that it's naturally formed, kind of like ore, if you know, like iron ore, gold ore, silver ore.
Okay.
got gold and silver in it, as well as other elements. But the majority of it is gold and silver, and it's can be molded together almost like an alloy, but it's naturally occurring. That's called electrum.
Okay, well, good. I mean, I got you.
So with liquid electrum, it would be like that being melted down.
Well, you know, that's kind of like oil. You know, I thought for years that oil was, once you pumped it dry, I thought it would never come back. That's just not the case. And check me out on this, you know, but oil is literally regenerated by the earth. You know, before the studies I've done, before you can even pump a well dry, the earth has replenished that well.
I remember you saying that the other day.
Yeah, it's just amazing, you know, when you get to looking into things, because we're always told, you know, that oil, you know, when a well runs dry, that's it. But that's not the case.
Yeah.
And that's just one point in so many others that we've been taught over the years that are not right.
Yeah.
You know, like some of the big debates we get into on there.
Look at this. Liquid electrum's making me blush. But it's interesting, Ronnie. If you ever come over to the Salivate Metal channel on the live streams, it's a ton of fun. And I remember, on the one live stream, Liquid Electrum had actually put that into the chat. It was, can you define electrum? And I couldn't. I had to look it up. So
I sure didn't know what it was. But it did remind me of the oil thing. That's why I brought that up.
Yeah.
Right on, Jim. Man, I've learned some things today, too.
Sweet.
And talking to Wolverine a while ago was a good experience. And to you, of course. I mean, I know you're very knowledgeable in all this. That's why I jumped on when I saw you on today. Because most of the time, I don't even get a notice that you're on.
Well, this stream, I set it up and scheduled it about 40 minutes in advance. And I know sometimes YouTube has a tough time getting all the notifications out, especially if it's on short notice, if you just fire it up live.
Okay.
And look at this. We have provoked the lovely Terry79. And look at the response I got.
Spit.
Yep. And so that is due to, because she likes to tease Sal, which is the nickname for Salivate Metal. That's what everyone calls him. And so anytime that we talk positively about Terry, she tends to spit on the ground. But.
Well, I got to ask now, what does spitting on the ground imply? I mean, I honestly don't know. So I'm. Is it a good thing or a bad thing?
I think that it's in jest. It's for fun.
I got you. That's what I thought. But that's,
yeah. At the end of the day, I don't want to speak for Terry. Like Wolverine said earlier, she can certainly speak for herself, and she'll tell me She'll tell me right off if I upset her too much. And she actually tried to ban me from my own channel once.
Really?
She loves timing people out. Anyone that doesn't have a wrench in here is subject to getting timed out by Terry79 for no reason other than fun.
Well, that's happened to me a few times too. Yeah. Don't have to do anything. Just let them know you're there. Garrett hit me one time. I just come into Rescue's channel, and Garrett was there. I didn't have a wrench because, you know, losing the channels. And I hadn't had a chance to give me a wrench yet.
Yep.
So as soon as I come in, Garrett times me out.
Yeah. It's funny. A lot of, like I went on some of the karaoke streams that are run by Asian people. Like, you know, Ms. D, for example.
Oh, yeah.
But a lot of them don't call it a wrench. They call it a jacket.
Yeah. Yeah, when I first heard that term, I had no idea what they were talking about. But yeah, I do.
K79, you just calm down. Calm down there. We're just having a little bit of fun. And thanks, LSP, for posting Salivate Metals channel. That's definitely one of my favorite precious metals channels. And he live streams every Tuesday, Friday, and Sunday nights at 6 p.m. Eastern. And 99% of the time, you'll see me there. And from time to time, you'll see quite a few of the other people in here, too.
We know JM... 79 said, you're getting on my nerves, JM. 79, all I can say is he tends to do that to people, you know.
Yeah.
No, JM is one of the easiest going guys I've ever met. He honestly is. Very knowledgeable, but he's very easy going, too. Like, just a genuine good guy.
I'm pretty casual. I had a pretty intense life when I was growing up, so... yeah, now I don't mind at all. Just kicking back, chilling and relaxing. I still work hard, but yeah, especially when I'm online, you know, I'm relaxing, chilling, having some fun, or just being entertained.
Yeah, I got you. That's where a lot of people are, you know. This, I guess, I mean, you know, I guess it's a learning experience, and no matter how much you know, you can always learn a little something, you know, if you listen long enough, I guess.
Yep, like right here, LSP's dropping some knowledge. YouTube's switched it, so there's two different levels of moderators now.
Certainly is.
And 79, I'm pretty sure if I don't make her a managing mod, she's going to start a riot in here. She's got her own gang, Ronnie.
Yeah, really?
Yep. Ask her.
Her own gang.
Yep.
Well, they call it 79ers.
Yep. And you know what, Ronnie? If you, as you get to know her, I wouldn't be at all surprised if down the road you join her gang.
I might just slip that. Maybe she'll join mine.
Yeah.
The Ronnie York gang. Well, that'd be cool. You know, we could go ride shotgun on each other's channels.
Look at this. See? There you go, Ronnie.
Well, if she's a managing mod, she could.
Yep. Okay, so the chat's going fast enough. I may not be able to highlight all of them, but you guys can read them anyway in the chat there. The main reason for highlighting these on the screen here is so that if, you know, something happens, if there's a copyright issue or you have to cut out some of the show, it kills the comment section on the live stream. So by highlighting these, you can still kind of see what was going on there. And LSP is an awesome person too. Absolutely. And I appreciate you posting those links too, my friend.
Yeah, LSP's a good guy too. He don't want to admit it, but he is.
Yep. And he's a moderator on some top-notch channels too.
Now that I didn't know, but
yes.
Right on LSP.
Yep. Fantastic moderator.
Yeah, I've known LSP, I don't know, for a long time now. I don't even know, remember when it was we ran into each other, but it's been a long time ago, 2 or 3 years ago, whatever.
Yep.
But he's an all-around good guy with a good heart, I'll put it like that.
And I met all you guys, like, from your side of my channel, Ronnie, through Deeds, linking up with Steve.
Well, didn't I know you before Deeds, though? I think we met, it was through Deeds. You're right. Yeah.
Like initially, but Steve, Deeds got me on to Steve, and then very shortly after, Conspiracy Music, and then suddenly, boom, I was subscribed to about 100 other people.
Indeed is a trip, man. I'm telling you.
Yep.
He definitely is. I love giving him a hard time. He gives me one back, of course. But...
And he's dealing with his, I think it was his mother-in-law or father-in-law passed away.
Yep. Yep. It was his Minion's dad.
Yeah. And I haven't seen or heard much from him in the last week.
No, I guess he's been kind of hanging around the house and keeping low. I know it can be a traumatic experience, you know, for it don't matter which one it is, if it's your parent or your wife's parent or whatever, you know, yep. The more traumatic it is for them, the more traumatic it is for you.
Yeah. And I have a tough time going to funerals because for many reasons, but I think one of them is seeing so many friends and family mourning. It's very, very difficult to see that. In the fact that you've lost, you know, someone that you love.
And I mean, it's been a good 15 years ago, but my sister was taking her daughter and granddaughter, the baby was only about 2 months old, to the doctor one morning. And it was, you know, time for the baby's checkup. And so she was driving to the doctor. It was real foggy. And the road came to a T. And you know, my sister had a stop sign, but she didn't see it because of the fog. And she missed that stop sign and ran right up under a big old 18-wheeler. And an 18-wheeler just chewed the car, you know, all to pieces, killing her daughter and granddaughter on the spot. And she died just a little while later, you know, from all the injuries. But now this is in Kansas, and I live in Texas.
Yep.
But at the funeral, oh man, I'm telling you now, my niece's husband, you know, my sister's daughter, oh, he was just, man, he was tore up so bad, just crying something terrible. And my mom, the same way. It was a terrible, terrible experience, you know. I mean, just watching, you know, knowing what they were going through was just terrible for me. And you know, all of my other brothers and sisters, it was just bad. And man, I tell you what, I don't even want to go to my own funeral.
It's a tough one to avoid.
It is.
I don't either. But I figure at some point I'll be ready, probably in my 90s. If Terry doesn't break my legs first.
I bet.
Liquid, CoinGeek sounds familiar, but
that was a terrible, terrible day.
Yeah. If you want to post CoinGeek's link, feel free, Liquid. I don't think I've seen that one. So what are you doing tonight, Ronnie? I haven't looked back at YouTube to see if and who is going live tonight.
Well, I intended to go live tonight, but I announced it last night on the channel. But when I announced that I was going live tonight, I had forgotten that I got a doctor's appointment early in the morning.
Tomorrow.
And you know how ours goes; it can go 4 to 5 hours easily. So I just decided to delay it till tomorrow night, so I won't be on tonight.
Okay.
So it'll be tomorrow night at the earliest, and probably tomorrow night. But I was going to show a video from somebody else, so mainly tonight anyway. So it wasn't no great big thing.
Okay. Oh, look at this. Terry 79's turned around. Showing them up.
Absolutely.
Okay, so, coin. Yeah. Yep, go ahead, Ronnie.
No, I was going to say, you see, if you wait around a few minutes, people will change their minds. And she loves you now. She hated you a minute ago.
Yeah, you just wait. She's a firecracker. Can definitely say something wrong. So I might throw a little bit of music on in the background here. I don't know how much longer you're good to stay up here. I could probably stay up another 20, 30 minutes.
Yeah, I'm fixing it to get off here pretty quick because I got to want to, you know, do some necessary Ronnie cleaning.
You're not seriously going to sweep, are you?
No, I don't ever sweep. Yeah, that has to be a very, very serious occasion for me to sweep. I'm going to take a shower and get my butt ready for bed, is what I'm saying.
Right on. I actually wouldn't be surprised, though, to see you do some house cleaning there now that you got that nice new spot. I can see in the previous place, you know.
Well, believe it or not, Jim, I have swept one time since I've been here. I literally got a broom out and swept the floor.
Yep. I believe it.
It broke my heart to do it, you know, because I'm not known for that, but I was forced to do it.
Yeah, you had to break precedent.
I did. And I'm telling you, man, I hate housekeeping so much. I can't even put it into words. I need maids coming over LSP, no doubt about it.
Yeah. Oh, here's a good one from Liquid. Let's talk silver prediction. Or silver prediction? Yeah, my prediction, I actually put it in the comment section of one of Salvate Metal's videos today. Just so you guys know, Salvate Metal typically does two videos a day, plus he live streams three times a week. And my prediction for silver for year end is, and I'm betting on this, is that it will close year end between 15 and 35. It's about 25 right now.
So you really don't think it's going to change much at all. I mean, it could lose 10. Is that what you're saying?
Yep. It could lose, it could drop 10. Yeah, it could drop 10, could be up 15. And I figure that's a safe bet.
Yeah, it sounds pretty safe to me.
Ultra safe. But the way I do it, I mentioned this earlier too, is I typically am not buying on a regular basis now. Whereas when I was when I felt I was way behind, I was buying as much as I could, silver and gold, and a bit of platinum as well. But now, you know, I don't feel like I'm that far behind the game. So now I just wait for the big smackdowns. When I see a big smackdown in the price, then I'll buy. But when it's smooth sailing and it's cranking up, I hold off and I'm just building up cash.
What is platinum going for right now? You remember?
I had it up there before. I think it's right around 15.
That's pretty reasonable.
1500 an ounce.
Well, and like I was saying a while ago, and this is the reason I'm so, if you call it bullish on silver, it's why I bought it anyway. It's because of what the world is going through right now. And what I'm thinking is, and I could be totally wrong, but this is just simply my thinking, is that I know that the richer people, you know, can afford to buy a lot of gold, but so that is going to my way of thinking again, is going to make a lot of people, you know, like me, which most people in the country are, go to silver or something else, you know. So silver's about in the middle, you know, so that's kind of where I landed at, and that's where I'm basically, I basically staked everything to this point. I'm not saying that I'm right. I'm saying that for me, that's right.
Yep.
And I just know that the shape the world is in with, you know, all these countries refusing to take the dollar. And I mean, our monetary system is in a mess. And something's going to have to be done about it one way or the other. So, you know, until you know that for sure, what's going to happen, you know, and it don't matter really if it's, well, it matters to me, but I'm saying that, you know, to the typical way of thinking, don't matter if it's good or the bad side, whichever way you look at it, does it, until it's done, you know, you've got to kind of look out for yourself and your family, you know, so how are you going to do that? And everybody has a different opinion on that.
Yeah.
I just know what mine is, you know.
Right now it's saying platinum is $1,122 an ounce US. So that's cheap. Like there was years when platinum was more than gold.
Where where do you buy your metal from, JM? Do you go to a dealer or what?
Most of the time I go to local coin shops. Oh, look at this. I left Terry's comment on there for a long time. I was just on another tab there looking up the platinum price. Yeah, I like coin shops, but I also know several other people that have been stacking metals for a long time. And every once in a while, one of them will want to raise some cash for whatever, and I can buy from them peer-to-peer. I've done that maybe seven or eight times.
So you get kind of a deal on it from time to time.
Yeah, like what we'll do is for silver, for example, if say silver spot price is 25 and the coin shops are selling at 30, we'll strike the deal at 27.50.
I got you.
Right down the middle.
You're coming out better than you're doing much better at buying it than what I did. There are no, at least that I know of, no coin shops around here. And so what I decided to do, and I thought about this for a while, but I thought, well, I'll just go with a reputable firm. So that's what I did. And but when, people I go through, they charge $2 to $4, whatever. And so that makes the price go up, of course, but it's not that much difference.
Yeah. And so now Niels Han Dynasty has just come into the chat here, Ronnie. And he keeps up on platinum more than most people I know, and certainly more than me. So if you want to post your link in the chat there, Ronnie might subscribe to you. But Neil, actually, I think you guys might have met. But either way, both you, Ronnie, and Neil also keep up with geopolitics. Like Neil focuses more on the finance, whereas your topics are more broad-based, yeah, but
exactly.
Definitely you guys are on the same thought pattern with a lot of things that I've seen.
Well, I definitely need to subscribe to him. No doubt about it. I like to hear a lot of different points of view, other than my own, but most of them I'm stuck with my own, whether I like it or not.
Yeah. You won't hear it. And since
let me take 30 seconds. Let's see. Where am I at here? Yeah, I'm way, way behind. I gotta on the chat. I got to go to my phone. Well, if I can get it to catch up.
On the chat side.
Yeah, my phone ain't wanting to, it won't let me catch up where we're at right now.
Are you still using a hotspot, or are you plugged into internet now?
No, I'm plugged in.
Okay, so it's not that. And since Neil's here, I might just pull up the platinum chart in a minute. We'll take a look at that again. One of the things you'll see, if you ever see Neil kicking around on the YouTube streets, Ronnie, is his favorite line is buy platinum and silver.
Or oh, really? Buy
silver and platinum. Yep, that's... he's not so big on gold, whereas, when we had Silver Wolverine in here before, he's more of a gold bug. So it's great to get opinions from all these different people, and nobody knows everything, but we can all learn from each other. Well, that's why we meet each other.
Definitely. That's exactly what I say, Jim. You can't ever learn anything from one person or one stream, whatever. And by the way, Neil, I've subscribed to you. So you'll be seeing me in your chat from time to time. But it's, it just pays to get a, diverse opinions, because, you may listen to one person, they have this idea and it sounds good. You listen to the other person, they have a totally different idea. But it sounds good. So where are you going to come down at? Are you going to, for myself, once I see those two different opinions, well, then I try to hit the middle and go both ways from there. Yeah. Check them both out. But you don't know until you have both those opinions and maybe three or four opinions.
Yeah. Hey, LSP, does I can't tell from here if Neil has a wrench. I think he does. But yeah, if either of you want to, Neil's definitely a great person. And anyone, you know, that I don't know well enough, I wouldn't, you know, be saying, oh yeah, go check them out. I don't just say that. It's because they are, in my opinion, really good people, or I wouldn't do that. Let's share this screen here. Yeah, and just so, yeah, so you guys know, just like I do a lot of dog videos, Neil does a lot of cat videos.
Well, y'all don't want to run into each other on the streets, do you? You with all the dogs and then with all the cats. Might be a war there. Wait,
you know what, Ronnie? He rescues dogs and cats. He's got his own rescue going there.
Well, wonderful. Well, I was going to drop my link again, but it ain't. For some reason, my phone is kind of crazy right now. It won't let me drop my link. So I was going to drop it again in case anybody wanted to.
Well, I'll. Yeah, and worst case, I'll drop it in a minute. You're okay. Just hold on. It'll come up. Just hold on.
There it is.
There we go. Okay, so I just got to go back there and get rid of the ad. Yeah, so this is showing platinum prices historically. So going back to 1969, where it was $180 an ounce. It can have very, very explosive moves up and down. So like it went from 160 an ounce to almost 1,000 in a matter of a couple of years. The highest that it's got was very close to 2,200. And right now it's, what does this say? About 1,114. And if I just pull back the time frame here, I'll see that. So. And you got to be aware of this with silver and platinum and gold to a lesser extent, in my opinion. You can have massive drops, but usually when you have these massive drops, they're short-lived.
Yeah, I got you. Well, you know, I was talking to my guy yesterday, the guy I buy the silver from, and I was, you know, kind of pumping him for information, you know, from his point of view. And he was kind of reluctant to give it. And out of somewhere in the conversation, he said, well, he said, understand that I'm not a financial advisor. And I said, well, you know, I understand that. I said, but I'm just asking for your personal point of view on, you know, where you think things are going and, you know, what you think, what you would do. And so he did tell me, and they're pretty close to my own views. So, you know, I said, well, you know, I appreciate it. And, they're very close to my own views, and which they were. And but that's why I wanted his opinion, you know, because if I had a guy that was saying, you know, some crazy thing, well, I might, you know, just go look for another place to buy from the next time, because you don't know, you know, if they're saying something crazy, they might be crazy. You know, you never know. So, it's just the way my mind works.
Yep. Sorry to hear about those cracked ribs, Neil. I've never had cracked or broken ribs, but I've had bruised ribs before, and holy cow, did that hurt.
You're kidding.
I thought for sure they were cracked or broken, but no, they're badly bruised. It took, well, I bet you it took 8 weeks for me to, you know, be feeling back to 80% even.
Well, I broke four ribs in a car wreck in 1992, and one of those ribs went through my right lung that was broken, and they were super painful, but mainly when I laughed, you know, if I didn't laugh, for the most part, it's okay.
Or sneeze.
Yeah. But now, Chap, he had all of his ribs, I've forgotten which side it's on, but all of them, I think it's all of them, they were so broken, they had to put metal ones in. So, and he's still in, you know, that, you know, he says he's still in a lot of pain all the time, and I can believe it because I know how damn painful those rips are, man.
Yep. Yeah, Big Chop was in a massive wreck. I think he said it was like a four-wheeler, one of those ATVs.
It was. He went run down a hill or something on it. I forgot now exactly what he said, but pretty sure he ran off the road down a hill.
Yeah.
Kind of like a mountainside. Not a mountainside, but close.
Yeah. That would do it.
I know he showed,
yep.
He showed the x-rays one night. I think it was x-rays. And man, I'm telling you what, it was a bloody looking mess. I put it like that. It makes you feel for him, you know.
Did you ever drive a motorcycle, Ronnie?
Yep. You stoned one, and I'm glad I don't know why. It's a wonder I didn't kill myself on it.
That's what I was thinking too. And you know, I've lost a lot of friends on motorcycles.
I've only lost one of them. He wasn't a close friend. Now, I'd known him for a long time, but we weren't what you call close friends. But he was driving down the road, JM, on the motorcycle, and he always wore a baseball cap, and he had the baseball cap turned around backwards. At least that's the way he wore it most of the time. But this one day, he had it the other way, you know, on front. And the wind blew it off, and he reached to grab the cap. And when he did, he had a wreck on the motorcycle, and he got killed.
Dang.
Yeah, they're very easy, man, to lose your life on. I see people riding around here all the time that are just plumb crazy. I mean, they were going in and out of cars, going out of that. You know, I'd be going 80 miles an hour sometimes. They pass me like I'm sitting still on the wrong side, on the shoulder of the road in a lot of cases.
That's crazy. I definitely had a need for speed when I was younger. Mm-hmm. And I had several motorcycles. None of which were Harley. But I had several of those dual purpose, which is like a dirt bike that's also street legal.
Yeah.
And I had several sport bikes as well. And when I look back, it's like I remember some very, very close calls. So I'm very grateful I never got seriously injured.
Well, you know, talking about a Harley, JM, I just wonder if I've never seen anyone on a Harley drive like that before. And I'm just wondering if when you're far enough along or whatever to be able to afford a Harley, maybe the better senses have kicked in, you know, and you don't drive like that. I'm just saying, I've never seen one go that fast. I know they'll go that fast, but I've never seen any rider drive them that fast.
Yeah. Oh, I had a buddy, he had a Yamaha R1, which was a super sport bike, and he got it when it first came out, 1,000cc. And man, would he fly on that thing. I know, because I tried to keep up with him on mine. Mine was a 800cc, and he'd just leave me in the dust. So yeah, LSP, yep, also known as Enduro. In fact, I'll show you here what I'd actually like to get. I think that's what it is there. Yeah, we'll just bring that up. There we go. Yeah, actually,
was this your back, JM, or whose was it?
No, this is what I'd like to get.
Oh, okay.
And actually, I got the wrong one, but it's actually called a KLR. Like this thing here. See if you can see that.
Yeah.
It sometimes takes a second to pull it up.
Yeah, it's up.
But these are fun. I had lots of these. Okay. So it's slow on my end. I had three or four bikes similar to the one, the green one, that's the largest one. Hey, Finding Kino, good to see you. And those are a heck of a lot of fun, you know, because you can still get them up to 100 mile an hour, but typically you wouldn't want to really go over 60 or 70, but they're fast enough you can go on the highways. But they're also awesome for off-road, getting out into the country.
Yeah, you can tell by that. Well, are you talking about the one that's standing alone by itself in the big picture on the right, right? Is that the one you're referring to? Okay. Because there's another one over here that's 650. Yeah. And there's another one over here in the lower left-hand corner that's got the knobby tires on it. That's just off-road, right?
That's right. Yep, exactly. So the one on the bottom left won't even have the signal switches or nothing on them.
Yeah.
It probably is not street legal. So with those, a lot of the time they're two-stroke, whereas the street legal will more frequently be four-stroke.
Gotcha.
The nicest bike I ever had was a, I'll show you, 2000. It was years ago. I haven't had a bike in years now. And this thing was awesome. Like, if you go back onto YouTube and after the show and punch this in, you know, the road tests and whatnot, they're awesome. Sort of a medium-sized sport bike.
Yeah, those are all crotch rockets. I mean, no wonder.
Yeah, it's kind of middle of the line. It's not the super, super sport bike. So they're still comfortable enough in the city. Yeah, it's going to give me the small picture of it.
But, well, I had mine in 1974, and it was a Honda, the best I remember. Now, it was either a 600 or 800.
Yeah,
CC. But I know that sucker would go, whatever it was, man. It would go plenty fast. I'd almost give myself a heart attack. But it was a lot of fun.
Yeah, but I got they to are. Even money. Like,
I'm sorry, Jim.
Yeah, I was just going to say that the smaller the bike is, the more nimble they tend to be.
Yeah, and that's why. And somebody had a. But I mean, I bought it used, and whoever owned it before me, I bought it from a dealer, but whoever bought it before me, had it before me, had changed out rear ends on it. Now, this is what a friend of mine said that was, you know, real big into motorcycles. He said it had a Harley rear end on it. I don't know if that's true or not. I didn't know it then. I don't know it now. But all I know is it would whine forever, you know, in fourth gear. You could just, it would go in fourth gear. As far as you couldn't hardly tell the difference when you changed from fourth to fifth. And so it was just a running sucker, is what I'm saying.
Yeah. So fifth gear really was a true overdrive just for fuel efficiency.
That's what it seemed. Yeah. And now he said it was because of the rear end in it. Now I don't know, but that's what he said.
Yeah.
I mean, I just bought it, you know, for the pure fun of riding it. Now, I'm not a motorcycle guy, I never was, but it was a lot of fun.
One of my best buddies is big time into Harleys. He loves Harleys. He knows more about Harleys than anyone else I know. And I'd actually love to have him on the panel on a discussion on that, because every time he gets one, he ends up putting between 50 and 100,000 into upgrading it.
Well, he's got a pretty penny in that thing. Well, he's already got a pretty penny in it. The 100,000, he's got a bunch of pretty pennies in it. Lord.
Incredible. And I do actually have some pictures of it from being stock to being fully customized. You know, the last one he had it bored out, suspension lowered, all the chrome, and it's all Harley Davidson stuff, so you know it's big money. Upgraded the exhaust. Then he put a turbocharger on it, like a supercharger. And then he said that it still wasn't fast enough, so he put a nitrous kit on it.
Well, I wonder, JM, in the long run, let's say you buy a Harley, you know, for the value, not only it has now, but in the future, you know, at a say 30, 40 years down the road, would all these, and I know it's done through Harley and all, but would all these upgrades, do you think hurt it in the long run or does it help it? Okay, I honestly don't know.
I think that it's kind of subjective in that if you keep it all Harley upgrades, it you might actually get some of your money out. But my understanding for the most part is a lot of it, you won't get your money back. But there's a lot of bikes out there. You know, you look at Orange County Choppers and all these people that do the custom stuff.
Yeah.
Things like that, you can certainly get your money out of.
The reason I ask, because I used to watch the channel all the time, and that's what they, you know, a big part of their thing was, is going around finding old Harleys, well, any kind of motorcycle, but particularly Harleys, you know, old ones. And yeah. when they found one that was, you know, pretty old and was stock, oh, these guys were head over heels in love, and there barely was a limit on what they would offer you in money for it.
Yeah,
but they wanted it all stock, you know.
Yeah,
that was just these guys. Now, I know there's other ones, but that's why I asked.
Yeah, and I don't follow the market enough, but if I had my friend on here, he'd be telling you, he'd talk all night about it.
Yeah, yeah, I know it takes someone that really knows, you know, but I just wanted your opinion. So.
Yeah. Well, hold on, I wanted to put Neil's link that he put here. That's the link to his last live stream. Bill Holter pissed him off when he spoke about platinum not being money. Yeah, when so Joe, there you go.
Fact.
Anyone that wants to know about platinum, go link up with Neil's Han Dynasty. He's definitely very positive and bullish on that. And I know part of it is because the majority of the supply of platinum comes from South Africa. Or let's just say Africa. Neil, he'll correct me if I'm wrong. But they're going through an energy crisis right now. And we all know that mines require a ton of energy. Mm-hmm. And so the majority of the platinum producing mines in Africa have been shut down due to the energy crisis there. So I know he's kind of looking at platinum has lots of different applications, especially as a catalyst. And there's lots of industrial applications for it as a catalyst that people don't realize yet. That most people
don't realize. Isn't platinum what's in the catalytic converters on a car?
Yeah. My understanding is most of the vehicles, like your car or your truck, is actually palladium.
Maybe that's what I heard. I don't remember, but I know it's a expensive metal, and the converters are very expensive.
Yeah. One is for gas powered and the other is more for diesel, platinum versus palladium. And I'm sure Neil will put in there which is which.
Yeah, and he just said BRICS control, nations control 95% of all platinum mines.
There you go.
And it's kind of strange, you know, at least my way of thinking, that, you know, South Africa is one of the BRICS nations and they're having an energy crisis, you know. And the reason I say it is because the dollar, you know, is based on petroleum for the most part.
Yeah,
and so it just seems strange to me.
Yeah, that's, and it was they called it the petrodollar.
Exactly.
Cummins Diesel is now making hybrid hydrogen diesel engines. They need more platinum for that.
Yeah, yeah. Here in California, is right on the verge of outlawing diesel of any kind. Maybe they already have. I hadn't kept up with that close, but last I heard, they were getting very close to it.
And I'm pretty sure I heard that Toyota is backing out of or backing off of their investments into going pure electric vehicles. They're saying the test case for going pure electric, we're not there.
Well, it's gotta be, so?
It's got to be hybrid. So they're reinvesting more into hybrid, and I believe it's going to be not just gas electric, but also gas hydrogen.
I can see that. Well, you know, to me, you have to ask yourself a question. What if we go all electric? Well, first of all, you got to be able to find a charging station to do it with, to charge it up with. If you're on a trip anywhere that's over 100 miles, but even if you can find one every other block, well, then where are those charging stations getting their energy from? Well, they're getting it from most time from oil or coal based. So, you know, it don't make any sense to me.
Yep. It's a shell shuffle. The only real case for them saying that the electric has lower emissions is for in the big cities where they're being operated, but they still have to download the pollution somewhere else.
I got you. What is it? If bricks uses platinum in their new currency, they could add platinum to you. The commodities back currency and raise the price of platinum as they wish.
Do you think they're going to do that, Neil? Like, that's interesting. Platinum backed currency. Both platinum and palladium are well known as catalysts. I'm not too sure about that, Neil. More platinum on the moon?
Yeah, I would have to see a couple of mines there first. I don't know. That's a whole different other subject there.
Yeah, I'm sure Neil, he'll do a video on it or a live stream, or he'll tell us here. He won't just say something like that without having something backing it up. So my question on it would be, how can they actually verify that?
Well, that's exactly what I'm saying. Yeah, I agree.
The truth is, platinum is extremely rare. It's like 10 times as rare as gold. So, you know, you wouldn't need to have a terribly large deposit of it to exceed what we have here.
Well, JM, I'm going to have to get off here, brother. Thank you for having me up.
Hey, Ronnie, okay. You've been a great co-host and helped me through this. I really appreciate it.
Oh, man, you're more than welcome. I thank you for bringing me up. And appreciate Wolverine earlier and all the folks in the chat. It's been interesting.
That's right on. Well, and that's one of the things about going from channel to channel is you're going to run into new people, and it will build your network. And when it's being hosted by someone you know, they're already kind of pre-screened, which is beautiful. That's one of the things I love about going to other people's channels. Like, I can tell right away anyone that's got a wrench, you know, probably they're good people.
And that's exactly the way it is in my chat. Unless I know the people, I don't give them a wrench to begin with. You know, they have to been there a few times first. Hey, that I knew them pretty well from someone else's channel.
Yep.
But yes, sir, that's exactly it. I mean, you know, like Shane and people like that, you know. Known Shane a long time. So that's
Shane Phelps?
Yes.
And I've just got to know him, man, maybe just in the last month.
Yeah, Shane's a good guy. I mean, you know, easy to get along. He's smart, easy to get along with. And, you know, it's like Shane and I don't agree on everything. We had a debate on my channel one night.
Did you?
So it's not. A debate, you know, as far as I'm concerned, has nothing to do with friendship. It's just like that little difference of opinion you may have on one thing, you know. But we have no hard feelings over the debate whatsoever. that night nor now. We get along great. That's the way it ought to be.
Yep. And sometimes when there's differing opinions on something, the truth ends up being somewhere down the middle. So having exactly. those debates lets you see how far, you know, how far off from center you are.
Yeah. And it's, you know, it's the same, well, most of the time, with, you know, when I'm on, it's me and Chap to begin with. And so, you know, we already have a list of things 100 miles long go over, you know, but a lot of times, you know, I know I've brought you up several times and you've always been a great addition. And Samoan, he's always been a great addition. Shane, he's, you know, everybody's been, but that's why that I like to bring you guys up, because it, you know, in that particular subject, it adds more to the show.
Yep.
You're very wise in the money and everything. And that's why I love to have you up on those nights we're talking about that.
Yeah. Well, I appreciate that, Ronnie. And I appreciate you and everyone else welcoming me into their communities with hospitality. And it is fantastic. I forget who it was that said earlier in here, you know, in the old days, we used to get together around campfire and chat, and now a lot more putting it on the YouTubes.
That's absolutely right. I saw that, and you're absolutely, he was absolutely right. That's exactly how things are done nowadays.
Yeah. And this is something, and then I'll let you go. I know you want to get going here, Ronnie. I appreciate you being up here. I just wanted to highlight this one more time. Neil said, America can legally mint a $1 trillion coin. Not a gold or silver one. And he's right. There is, I don't know if you call it legislation or what, but there is that option for America to legally mint a $1 trillion coin. And guess what metal it has to be?
Gold?
Platinum.
Oh, really? Well, I didn't know that. But when was this law put into effect? I got to ask that.
I'm not sure. I believe it's one of those little known things that are written in there that they can, I think it's that they can any value on a platinum coin. I think it's an American platinum eagle. You know, they've got the gold eagle and the silver eagle.
Yeah.
But I think the gold eagle has to be 50. The silver eagle has to be 1. And from what I gather, the platinum can be anything they choose.
Well, the reason I asked about when the law was put into effect is because in 1897, and I'm pretty sure everybody knows this, but that's when a lot of things changed here in the United States, you know. And then after 1897, what I'm saying in a roundabout way here is that things that were done after 1897 may be changeable,
yep.
You know, in the future.
Yep.
And I don't want to go into it any farther than that, because I don't want to take a chance on doing you any damage. So I'll leave it there. But.
No worries. We'll catch up on your channel and Big Chop's channel, and that's where we can speak a little more freely.
Absolutely.
And dig into the details a little further. And as Big Chop would say, go down the rabbit hole.
Yeah. He's got the rabbit. Chop, I'll tell you what, man. He's been a... You know, for me, he's been great, you know, and you know, with us coming together the way we have. And I just want everybody to know, you know, that, you know, I appreciate Chap 100%.
Yep.
So, and that's not to say that I don't appreciate you and all my other friends, because I do, but I'm just talking about, you know, for as far as my show goes, you know.
Oh, yeah. Like, and he's kept up with the technology, so he can help you out with that.
Oh, yes.
You've got the history though, right? Like you've lived through more history than he has or I have. And most of what the knowledge that we have is based on our life experiences and what we've researched and learned.
That's exactly right, JM. Exactly. Well, he's like kind of like a son to me, you know, in a lot of ways. I mean, I know he's not my son, but I'm saying, you know, in a lot of ways, that's kind of what he's like.
Yeah. So liquid electrum, as far as no strikes, what happens is on the live streams, they can talk pretty much as freely as they want. And if they don't take the stream down after, meaning delete it, it would get strikes. So what they do is they delete the stream after. So it's, if you show up for the live stream, you get the information. And if you don't, you missed it.
That's right. And I sure hate to take them. That's what I said a while ago. I hate to take them down. And I know Chap does too, but you really got no choice to, if you want to speak openly, not only us, but, you know, whoever we have on, they don't have to worry about, you know, going here, going there, you know, to avoid a word or a phrase or whatever. You can speak with an open mind, you know.
Yep. And so I've learned from Ronnie that really the biggest reason that that he's on YouTube is to share the information and get the truth out to the best of his ability to as many people as possible. And look, oh, we've ruffled Terry's feathers. Got her.
But to leave my channel, I wouldn't be able to get a word out. Nobody's 79.
Don't delete the video. Delete the channel. Well, yeah. If we don't delete the video, YouTube will delete the channel for us.
For darn sure. They've done it on four of the other ones today, and they don't mind doing it.
Yep.
They got plenty of time, undoubtedly. Well, so that's great. Thank you, JM. Appreciate you, brother.
100%. Thank you. I'm going to shut her down here very soon, too.
All right, good night, bro.
Have a great night.
You too.
Okay, so that was a ton of fun. We had lots of good people up here. And what I'll do after the fact, once the live stream is finished processing on YouTube's end, is I'll put links to everyone that came up on the panel in the description of the live stream as well. That way it's duplicated. I appreciate LSP and Finding Kino posting links here. You guys are awesome. And everyone else. And so what I'm going to do for 79 mainly is I'm going to leave this stream running for another 5 or 10 minutes like this right here. And I'll just get some music going in the background so you guys can keep chatting. And I'll come into the chat as well, and I'll keep engaged with you guys on that. But we're just going to finish off with some music. If there's any other subjects you wanted me to cover, just put it in the chat, and I'll address it within a reasonable amount of time. Thanks again, guys. Appreciate you being here. I'm going to keep this running for a little bit longer, just with music. And all the music will be related to money. Thank you. You got it, Terry. Money is a hit. Money, it's a crime. Share it fairly, but don't take slice my pie. Money, so they say, is the root of all evil today. But if you ask for a rise, it's no surprise they're giving none away, 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 away. One more song after this one, but I'm shutting her down. Ah, now look at them yo-yos. That's the way you do it. You play the guitar on the MTV. Now that ain't working. That's the way you do it. Money for nothing and your chicks for free. Now that ain't working, that's the way you do it. Let me tell ya, them guys ain't dumb. Maybe get a blister on your little finger. Maybe get a blister on your thumb. You got to install microwave ovens, custom kitchen delivery. Hey, we got to move these refrigerators. We got some movies, color TVs. Mula mula. We got to install microwave ovens. Custom kitchen deliveries. We got some movies, refrigerators. We got some movies, color TVs. Look at us. Should've learned to play the guitar. Should've learned to play them drums. Look at that mama, she got it. Sticking in the camera, man. Could've had some. He's up there, what's up? Hawaiian noises, banging on the bongos, like a chimpanzee. Bro, that ain't working.
That's the way you do it. Get your money for nothing and your cheeks for free. You got to install microwave ovens, custom kitchen delivery. We got to move these refrigerators. We got to move these color TVs. Listen here now, that ain't working. That's the way you do it. Play the guitar on the MTV. That ain't working. That's the way you do it. Your money for nothing and your chicks for free. Money for nothing
and the chicks for free. Get your money.
We gotta save AC/DC for the last. This is the last song, and then I'll catch up with the chat and say goodbye to everyone. Taylor Toots, chauffeur cars, fine hotels, and big cigars, up for grabs, for a price, where the red hot. We're dancing through the night. The claim is on you, it's on me. So what do you do? That's guaranteed. A little girl, want it all. The furs, the diamonds, the painting on the wall. Come on, come on, for the money. Come on, come on, listen to the money talk. Come on, love it for the money. Come on, come on, listen to the money talk. A French maid, foreign chef, big house, king size bed. Had enough, you ship them out. The dollar's up. Later by the power, claim is on you, the sights are on me. What do you do? That's guaranteed. Hey little girl, you broke the laws. You hustle, you deal, you steal from us all. Come on, come on, love it for the money. Come on, listen to the money talk. Come on, come on. Money talks, bullshit walks. Thank you. nice. I can't believe that I didn't lose everybody here. I'm going to get rid of this background, and then I'll just give my final thoughts, and then we'll shut this down. We'll say goodbye, everybody. Hope everyone's having a good week so far. There we go. Thanks, everyone, for coming out. Appreciate it. I'm going to always try to save something like that for the end. So some people will, and some people won't want to stick around to the end. But either way, we always have a lot of fun here. All the people I had on the panel are great. Everyone in the chat was awesome. Appreciate you guys. Everyone, have a fantastic evening, and we will certainly see you guys very soon in the near future. Have a great night.
Winner.